Y'all couldn't write a nightmare without falling out of bed.
Recording has started.
Woohoo!
All right, we are back to a fire up roll 20, guys, when you get a second. We are back to, I believe this is session 3 of ETU, East Texas University. Last session we spent our time wandering about town, learning some of the ins and outs of Pinebox, Texas. You guys successfully won your one free pizza each a month or something like that. I forget what it was. It was easy food for you, hungry boys.
Guys, I'm getting a little sick of pizza. Can we just order a vegetarian one night? Maybe get some other types of food groups in our diet.
And you also had you competed against your roommates.
And one,
because they cheated.
By the way, guys on the line, it sounds like there might be some background noise, so you may want to put yourself on mute so the background noise doesn't get
through. Sure. I told you I was going to have to turn that off once we started.
Just stop breathing off.
Is there a fan going or something?
But you can just put it on mute, and then you can allow the background.
Yeah, but it's hard for him to chime in then.
Oh, that's true.
Is that what you want me to do?
No, I'd rather you not put it on mute if we can avoid it, because then I know it's hard for you to chime in, and you miss half the experience then. So.
That's a good point, Josh. My apologies, Joel.
So, all right. So you guys have done that. You had run into the. You may or may not have run into the Needler. Once or twice.
School classes start, I guess. And one thing you notice right off the bat is Edison. Looks like he's really tired all the time. He's kind of dragging. He's been late for classes. And you guys know one thing about Edison. Edison is never late for class. He's the kind of kid that shows up 15 minutes before class with like 5 different pens and pencils ready to go.
All different colors.
All different colors, precisely. He's also really cranky to you guys.
Johnny Moon looks really tired. Big bag under his eyes. He told you guys he's not sleeping well since that second possible run-in with the Needler or something weird.
Actually, I haven't been sleeping well since the roost.
I wonder if we're all like that, because I know Juan Lo is feeling a little run down. He hasn't been sleeping too well lately.
What's the roommate situation? Do we have the same roommates we were initially introduced to? I don't have Jordan Peacock anymore. Madison doesn't.
Right, you have Oz.
I have Oz. Okay.
They seem. It's hard to tell me. You're all in a state of flux. It's an entirely new environment. You're completely unsupervised. Half of them are staying up stupid late and doing stupid things. You know, sex, drugs, rock and roll. So it could be, you know, a change of environments or what. You guys have noticed that. Let's see here. You've noticed that this young lady has been spending some evenings with I'll get there.
Holy shit, I know that girl. No, I'm just kidding.
Actually, you probably do.
Are you getting a picture? We're not getting... Oh, there is a picture.
Oh. She's just spending a great deal of time with... What's your... What is it? Cochise.
And she looks like a gal with a long black hair tied in a ponytail and a t-shirt and a purse over one shoulder with kind of a good-natured smile.
Attractive, not stunning.
Yeah. What's her name? Missy Moon?
Not yet.
Whoa.
She's actually a recurring NPC. I chose to introduce this way. Missy Jordan. I shouldn't have picked Jordan for the other one.
You can change her name now?
No, because she's Missy Jordan and like three other adventurers if I choose to use them. And I can't do that to myself. Mm-hmm. So, all right. So you guys did have your night of the Goonies. You had all your stuff. We'll say it's a Thursday night, probably a month into school at this point. You've relatively adjusted, hanging out. I gave you a Thursday, so Mikey's not out getting loaded up somewhere.
Wait a minute. This is college?
Yeah.
It's Thursday. He's out getting loaded up somewhere.
It's Tuesday. Mike's out getting loaded up.
I know.
I remember in college, I used to drink on Thursday, do laundry on Friday, drink on Saturday.
I just drank Thursday, Friday, Saturday.
Yeah,
well,
I drink while I was doing laundry.
Yeah, there you go.
Just not as heavily.
So...
Guys, I was at the computer lab yesterday, and there wasn't a lot of people in the lab, so I decided to just do some investigation. I wanted to see if there were any reports of what that weird thing was that we saw in the alley. I know you don't believe me. None of you saw it except for Johnny Boone over there. But I'm telling you, there was something there. And so I looked for any references of the needle, and you know what I found? Nothing. Like, not even a reference in the wiki. Like, somebody had gone and deleted everything about the Needler.
Because we didn't come up with that name. That was the name that the dean gave us.
Yeah.
I saw that thing in the... I saw that thing in the gym. I know. If you saw it in the alley, I believe you.
Thank you, Arlo.
Hey, baby.
Hey there, Ian. How are you?
I mean, the only thing that I read was that it's been referenced in newspapers. So then I was like, to hell with this. I couldn't sleep anyways. I went to the university library, and I dug in the stacks, you know, where we did that scavenger hunt. And I was inspired by that stuff that Trout pulled, looking up for the actual newspaper.
So you pulled a fire alarm?
No.
That was a little much.
Well, here's what I found, and it's kind of weird. The Needler's been the scapegoat for odd things going on for years. It seems to come and go, but it's been used to explain strange animal and pet deaths. No one's able to exactly describe what it looks like, only having seen it in the shadows or looking like it was blended in the background. Several people have investigated and looked into it. You know that Detective Blaine Bishop that we met who put us in jail? Yeah, he investigated cattle killing several years ago.
Is Blaine the one that was in with the dean?
Yes.
That's
Danny Glover? Yeah, Danny Glover.
Danny Glover, yeah. And also, you remember Glenn Mack and Jackson Green? They, you know, that professor with his gadget when the auditorium went on fire? Well, I read the newspaper. They have an ongoing investigation into the Needler, and they will pay us money to go and find information for them.
I'm sorry, can you say that adventure hook again?
Yeah.
Wait, you said money? I mean...
Well, last but not least, I found one other item. Here, take a look at this newspaper right here. You see this guy, Tony Hidalgo? He runs Hidalgo Hardware and the Tractor Supply store.
I heard of him.
Did we meet him last week?
I think we heard about him. I don't know if we met him. They say that he's like an expert on local lore and legends, and he even served as the president of the Pinebox Historical Society. So that's what I got.
So you're saying we should go talk to him?
Yeah. I'm thinking we should go talk to that professor. Greenwood Mac.
Glenn
Mac.
Fleetwood Mac.
Fleetwood Mac.
Hey, you know what?
Steve Inks' birthday today.
You can go your own way.
Anyways, what do you say?
Let's go talk to him.
Yeah, do we know what his office hours are?
You do have contact with Glenn Mack. He was set up as your advisor after the events at the Roost, so you have his contact information, his office hours. You can get in touch with him easily enough.
Didn't pick the pilot's girl apart from his eyes?
I wouldn't say no. Of course, there's not much I would do at this point.
Uh-huh.
All right, so what are you up to?
Well, it says he's got office hours tomorrow morning. You want to go... pay him a visit?
Let's go find him.
Oh, now. Morning? I definitely don't have class.
You can go see him that day.
Oh, all right.
Sure.
Let's go see him.
Okay.
I'm off from work right now.
Oh, yeah, your work's there, you
know. All right, so you are visiting Glenn Mack, a.k.a. Daniel Jackson.
Josh, thank you for the extra Benny for dinner.
That's the rule, man. You made dinner, you got Benny's.
That's awesome.
So, you guys get to his office, conveniently. I don't want to get over there. Why didn't you center? There you go.
Oops. Oh, no, because I think maybe Adam was moving it.
He's there talking to Jackson Green, his graduate assistant.
Who looks like Daniel Jackson from Stargate 1.
No, that
would have been easy. He looks like
Matthew. Okay, fine. We'll switch them.
No, that's good.
No, we're going to switch them.
Okay.
So, Matthew McConaughey is now Glenn Mack.
Okay.
And Daniel Jackson is Jackson Green.
I think we have to start all over.
Yeah, let's go back 3 weeks. I'm so confused now.
All right, so we've now officially switched the pictures and the names.
So we're back at the Roost.
Guys, get out of the place. It's going to be set on fire. Nobody should hold it here. Yay, problem solved.
What's going on, guys? I was going to come see you. Me and the CIA, your first couple weeks went.
So, how are you guys doing? Y'all right, all right?
Yeah, I was.
All right.
It is Texas.
Come on, go for a ride, my
Hey, lady. Did you guys ever find anything at the Roost?
You know, it's funny. We've been hearing reports about some ghost sightings out there, but they won't let me go in and investigate.
Who's they?
The administration, the safety people, OSHA. Mm.
Where are these sightings been?
The workers. Some of the workers I've heard him mumbling about it.
At the Roost.
Some of them have left and not come back from the Roost.
Really?
Really.
Did they ever find the security guard who got pulled into the wall back at the opening day a few weeks ago? Did they ever find that guy?
Not that I'm aware of.
Wow. Could not be more peace.
You know, when we did the scavenger hunt, what was that, last week? 3 weeks ago?
Yeah, a while ago.
We heard a unearthly noise. Yeah, about 6 weeks ago.
Oh, six pizzas.
Six pizzas. Out in the alleyway, Johnny Moon and I saw something really...
It looked real similar to what we saw in that hallway.
Really? Can you describe it for me when he gets out a piece of... I don't suppose you can draw. Stick figure.
He's checking his skills list on his character sheet. Nope. Sure, I can give it a shot. He draws...
You didn't see it, though.
He draws a stick figure. With, like, fangs and a cape. And it looks like a...
Okay, son, you're useless to me.
We heard, you know what? We heard something from a alleyway.
Okay.
I sprinted over to investigate. We found a dead animal. And I saw what I thought was something to take the corner, and I ran up. And I saw what I thought looked similar to that kind of thing, where it was, like, spikes coming out the back.
Really?
Dark.
You're, like, the best description we've ever had of this thing.
And it just disappeared. It was there 1 second, and it was gone the next.
Wow. Because we've had people see the shadow. The shadow disappears. Mm. Well, can you give me more description of it?
It's kind of hairy, I think.
Hairy and spiky?
Because the body was hairy, but like the spikes coming out. Kind of humanoid face, but different than human.
Wow. That's something.
That's nothing.
It was long.
We hear that you're paying money to do investigations. Is that true?
If anybody can provide us anything concrete on this, there is certainly a reward for that.
All right.
Johnny Moon is holding out his hand, requesting payment.
Not yet?
No.
Okay.
Well, if we
you'll have to forgive me for not trusting a college student I barely know at his work.
Back there. Well, to be fair, we did save the entire freshman class.
That is your version of the story? I tend to believe that version because I know special things happen around here.
Thank you.
I don't need those.
Okay.
I tend to believe your version of the story, but you know the dean has his suspicions, as does Detective Blaine.
What is Detective Blaine's problem? It seems like he's not very supportive. And...
Well, we heard.
Go ahead.
We heard that he has done some research into this.
He has, and we've interviewed him.
Needler.
Something about some cattle killings a few years ago?
Yeah, a few years ago we had some random cattle killings. No, I mean, it takes a lot to kill a plow, you know? No bullets or anything, just animal torn to shreds. Several of them over the course of about a month.
Chupacabra cut by a laser?
No. Ripped to shreds. Ripped to shreds.
Chupacabra?
Some people have said that. But, I mean, that's, you know, the rumor, the legends of that is more of a dog. From what you just described to me.
No, I didn't know. It was definitely humanoid, what I saw.
Professor Mack, I'm wondering.
Just call me Glenn Mack.
What I thought was humanoid.
Fun, Professor. Just Glenn Mack.
All right.
Here, son. Here's $20.
I'm wondering, in all your investigations, have you ever collected proof of anything supernatural yet? Or are you more like the Sci-Fi Channel? You wander around in a house for an hour, and then you hear a noise, and that's pretty much, and then we go to a commercial break.
You forgot about the EKG. The EKG. The
PKE.
So special. Ah, the electrical interference.
Oh, right.
Must be
Do you have proof of something? Have you collected?
We have a ton of data we've analyzed. We've seen, like your night at the roost, we have infrared data showing hotspots all over where those ritualistic symbols are printed. Do we have proof of what happened there? No, but we have certainly a lot of information adding up to that.
Well, how hard would it be to sneak into that roost? And what would you pay money for? Like a picture of a ghost?
Excuse me. I now is not the time. I know that they're trying to get a bunch of stuff done now, but in about a week, things are going to quiet down there, and then maybe we'll see if we can figure something out.
Do you think you could land us some of your equipment so that when we go in there, we can better detect them and capture them?
That would be very amenable to me.
Is that Paris weekend? A couple weeks in, right?
Yeah,
we're
about
a month in from school, a month and a half.
Oh, your parents are coming?
No.
No, mine either. Yeah.
They can't leave the work for that long.
So come back in about a week. We'll see how things have changed.
All
right. But right now, the security's really tight.
And you'll train us up on these gadgets?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
All right. Well, that sounds like a good deal. Thank you.
I mean, obviously, if you find any proof or anything better of the needler, please, by all means. You know, I'd love to be able to give you some sort of stipend for that information.
All
right. I'd love to help you.
Well, have a good day.
You too.
I guess we can go
visit. Are there any other places that are kind of hot spots for this? Or just weird?
There's a reason I'm in Pinebox, Texas. The whole county.
All right.
There's, if you really want to go investigate some odd places, obviously you've been around town. There's a few special places in there, like the lady's coffee shop, the coffee and bookshop. She sells all kinds of ritual stuff. I believe you had to stop there as part of your scavenger hunt.
Yeah.
And
I think we told her we would stop back there at some point.
Oh yeah, you're right.
Yeah, I believe you sabotaged somebody with the trains at that point. That was really good.
That was Joel.
That was Joel. Trout did very well.
Trout sabotaged one of your competitors by saying he likes trains.
Oz likes trains.
He's just being a friendly guy.
So,
Professor Glenn Mack.
Yes.
You talk about in the bookstore they have rituals. What kind of rituals you talk about?
She has all kinds of ritual books and spirituality books and stuff.
Like how to make tea?
No, I mean she's got all kinds of stuff that just might be interesting. She might be worth talking to one day.
I think Tony Hidalgo might be a good.
Oh, Tony's the local historian. We talk to him all the time about this stuff. Now, if you do go talk to Tony, be prepared to have your ear bent and spend a few hours there. You know, it's like talking to Bob Jones.
The golfer? My God. I didn't know he was so talkative.
He's still alive?
Yeah.
He's still alive.
Another guy that's kind of interesting to talk to, his name is Paul Vanderhorn. And he showed up here maybe, how long ago did he show up here? He showed up about 20 years ago. And he had the idea that he was going to be the champion of the town. He ran into something that hurt him. He busted up his leg real bad. Now he just fixes stuff. Motors. And if you need a weapon, I've seen that guy make a crossbow on a piece of PVC pipe. And that thing went through a piece of 3/4-inch plywood.
YouTube is a marvelous thing these days. That's for sure.
He can make anything back there. So he's on 15 acres of property and tells you exactly where it is.
All right.
So.
And what's the nature of your collaboration, Professor? Your assistant? The two of you have been working together long? Is he your TA?
Yeah, he does. He teaches some of my classes. He helps out with stuff.
Is he just your TA? Is that what you're saying?
We both share similar interest in the paranormal around this area. So.
Well, I can't help but ask, what's the scariest thing you've ever seen? Give us the scariest, the weirdest thing you've ever seen.
Somebody's been a little territorial over there.
Out of at 3 a.m. Scariest thing I ever seen, huh? You know, there was this time.
It's scary, not sloppy.
I was investigating this ghost house, and everything got cold. And I saw this apparition.
Really?
She came up and she touched me on the shoulder, and he pulls his shirt back, and you can actually see a little mark on his shoulder, which is where the skin is slightly discolored.
Ooh.
And you know, I just don't know. I didn't know if I was gonna walk out of there or what was gonna happen. Hmm.
She do anything else, or you just
no? She just came in. She floated by.
Wow.
She looked at me. It was. She touched my shoulder, and it was almost like she said I had more to do.
Doc, did you see this on my arm?
Let me see that.
Johnny is showing the arm that he got grabbed by the creature, the fire creature. Okay.
And he goes. Hold on a second. He brings over a piece of equipment. And he's looking at it, and he plugs it into the computer. He's looking at it, and you can see. That when he goes from the part of your arm that wasn't touched to the part that was touched, the temperature reading increases about a degree.
Ooh, huh. That's cool.
So, I mean, it is healing. It's slowly fading. But
see that somewhere.
The exact shape of a hand.
Yeah.
So, I'm just understanding, as a mechanical engineer, you're telling me that there's a portion of your arm, which is 1 degree warmer, you have possibly the key to an unending energy source, when you think about it. I mean, that 1 degree of heat.
Oh, now it's back to normal.
why do you think my character has a mechanical engineering degree? Edison is fascinated, and he rambles on about the implications of this.
Except it's not infinite energy, because if he stops eating, I'm sure that'll go away.
Well, I'm thinking if you can capture this thing, harness it, you can use it to generate energy for me.
My arm isn't going to be captured. It's right here.
Johnny,
you don't need that whole arm, do you?
I'm talking about the creature that touched your bone.
Okay.
Yeah.
She was pretty cute.
Yeah. She was.
All right,
then.
For a ghost.
I'm sorry. She's pretty hot.
But up, bump.
Any other questions for Professor Matt? Joel, Mike, or is it Trout and Joe Duffy?
No, that is, yes, Trout and Joe Duffy.
Any extra questions on your side, guys?
Not here.
Joe Diffy?
No, Joe's good right now.
Okay.
He's still a little skeptical on this whole thing to start with, so.
Why does it look like we're doing
And he's really, really tired.
An interview with, like
ex-Scientologists
or something.
Hey, Joe, you're looking like a bit peaked. I have to say, I've been having trouble sleeping at nights. Have you been having trouble?
I haven't slept a whole night since we got to this place.
But is that because you've been partying until like 4 in the morning?
No, not at all.
Huh.
2.
Which is half the time I used to party at home.
Yeah, I've been having the same trouble. I get nightmares. It's crazy. I used to sleep like a log before. think it's something in the pizza?
We haven't, well, not for me. I was having nightmares before we got the pizza.
Yeah, you were?
Ever since the roost.
Really?
Well, the roost. I always used to be a good sleeper. Even now, I'm working, I'm playing football, going to class, and I still restless sleep. I don't know.
So, Trap, are you the only one that's sleeping well these days?
No, I'm not sleeping well either.
Oh.
I thought maybe it was the pizzas. Maybe a few too many, but I keep waking up in the middle of the night. Nightmares, sweating. It's pretty goofy.
Even when I don't sleep alone, I still wake up.
You're a freshman. You sleep alone all the time.
He's got Missy. Missy, you see Missy leaving in the morning sometimes.
Oh.
Big Jim sleeps with an apple pie, and Jim, and Coach G sleeps with Missy.
I didn't rule anything out.
Well, I'll tell you what, man. Maybe it's a good idea for us to go get some coffee and stay awake. We can hit the coffee shop at the same time.
Let's go talk to
the lady who owns the coffee shop.
Miss Delilah.
Hold on a second, I'll find her name.
Is it here?
I don't know if I gave it. I don't know if she's even in here. You know what? I have the mirror earlier. Where's the sheet planner? So you guys are heading into town?
Yeah, I think so. And we say our goodbyes to the professor.
Thank you. Good luck. Let me know if you find anything.
Thank you, sir.
It's Mary Lynn.
Mary
Lynn. Mary Lynn's Used Books and Emporium.
Oh, Jeff, well done. That was pretty good.
I just looked up.
Okay.
I just looked at my Evernote. So you had that. You had Tony Hidalgo.
Got it.
If you want to talk to him.
I think we'll start with a coffee shop, yeah.
All right, so you head on in. I assume you pile into whatever vehicle you have access to again.
Mm-hmm. I know Edison's got a car. It's a crappy car. It's got an engine problem. It doesn't always start.
Well, that's why we're here to help you push it. Is it stick?
Yeah, it's stick.
So you can pop it.
Yeah, that's true. It'll fit five uncomfortably.
How many of us are there? Five, okay. Because I know,
Mikey had the Jeep, but I don't know how well that fits five.
Mm. Wayne Bud's got a Harley, it doesn't fit five at all.
Oh, Wayne's got a Harley.
Oh, you hear it. Every time he starts it, the whole campus knows.
I'm surprised he's got an American vehicle, not a
Japanese
foreign.
My father bought it for me. We used to go on family outings. My mom would sit on the back, and we'd ride through the, out in the outskirts of Houston.
Houston? Lan Lee, you're from Houston? I thought you were from parts far away.
Oh, yeah, but I came into the U.S. into Houston a few years ago.
Oh, I didn't know that.
And somehow in the past few minutes I've also lost my accent.
Well, East Texas will do that to you.
Yeah. I might pick it up a little bit later than that.
Hey, Joel, do you have a deck of cards handy? It's okay if you say
David,
no. We need to pull something for the curse.
Any cards David. Around, David? Just a regular deck of cards.
If not, we got a deck here. Bob, we'll pull one for you.
Yeah.
Forgot to curse Joel's cursed, Trout's cursed effects table.
That's a fun curse.
That is pretty cool.
Mm-hmm.
Well, until it hoses him.
Yeah,
or us.
But the halitosis is pretty cool.
The halitosis is pretty cool.
The hard part is some of them are just like, how do I work this in?
Yeah.
And he may get off. It might be not applicable for one night. You never know.
Yeah.
Mikey's home again.
Oh. Yeah, we're home.
That doesn't look like America.
So how was your vacation trip?
It was good. It was nice. Nice to be away for a couple days.
You're always
not have
away
to think about work too much.
With his girlfriend.
Where did you go, Mike?
There's a little cruise line right out of West Palm Beach, which is about 30 minutes down the road, that you cruise over to the Bahamas, and then you get into like one of the resorts. So we stayed at this all-inclusive resort for a couple days, and then you get back on the ship and it takes you back home.
That is awesome.
Nice.
And
yeah.
I can't imagine how convenient it is to only have a half-hour drive when you get off the ship.
Seriously.
Yeah, it's not bad at all from a cruise perspective. I mean, so.
Fine one, Joel?
Yeah, I got it.
What do you got?
Oh, just I guess I better draw one, huh? Okay. All right, you want to hear something amazing while I'm shuffling this deck?
Always.
We went to the bowling tournament this weekend.
You bowled the tournament?
Do you remember a guy from Phoenixville named John Blandon?
Nope.
Okay. His son was bowling this year for the first time. His son's about 15 years old. He bowled a 279. He won all events.
Oh my God. The kid
out-bowled every single senior. He's amazing.
Wow.
He's going to be bowling in a national tournament in July in Chicago. A 279. Come on. That's
insane.
That's 50 points higher than any man bowled.
Hey, Jess. You know, my amazing bowling is like 150.
Yeah, my good bowling is 150, 160. All right, what do you got, Mr. Joel?
All right, here's my card.
Okay, it's not a magic card. That's good.
Nine of clubs.
Okay.
Is that my curse card?
He does not know what his curse is.
Oh.
Should I pick my curse card?
That is your curse card.
Oh, okay.
No, wait a minute.
But Joel, I guess you don't get to know what your curse is until it comes into play later in the game. I didn't realize that.
I can tell you. I don't.
That's okay. Whatever. However you want to manage it.
Do it for best dramatic effect.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I'll do it for best dramatic effect.
Or comedic. Yeah.
I'm good with that, too. All right, so where are you heading?
So we're headed to the coffee shop first.
Okay.
We're taking a seat. Is it really busy in there?
We're going to call it about 11 o'clock.
Okay, yeah.
That fair?
Yeah, yeah.
We visited Glenn Mac first, came here.
AM or PM?
AM.
Hey, don't we have class on a Tuesday?
This is Thursday.
That too. And
some of us are skipping and others don't have it.
Okay.
Probably. This is much more interesting.
Good point. Yeah. As long as it's not Sunday, tell this.
Coach East is skipping Native American studies.
I live it.
So we can tell.
I get a Benny for that one. I get a Benny for that one.
But I think he should get a Benny for she was hot.
So Mary Lynn is there. It's not that busy. Obviously, it's an odd time of the day between, you know, it's not lunchtime and it's not break time. There's another couple people and reading books quietly in corners, but you're pretty much the biggest group there. She comes over and asks
you.
What are
they wearing?
She's wearing a blue dress, very plain. Her hair's up in a bun.
No, don't you think that's Mary Lou or everybody
yes,
else?
Mary Lou. Okay. It's two men.
Bye. Mary Lynn.
What are they wearing?
Mary Lynn. What are they wearing? Whoa, this just took a wrong turn.
No, wait, I'm Christian. I can't do that.
There you go.
Have you got a decaf skinny mocha latte cappuccino with hold the whipped cream, please?
So this is Texas.
Yeah.
This is East Texas.
Yeah.
Pinebox. We have coffee.
Yeah.
And decaf coffee.
Oh. Oh, you have the skinny?
With and without cream.
Oh.
Or sugar.
Oh, well, may I have a decaf?
Hot sauce.
Please?
No soy,
Yeah.
Extra
foam.
Do you have rice milk? No? No rice milk?
So we have cream.
Oh.
Why would you want rice milk when you could have cream?
Because it makes my tummy not good.
So do you like your coffee then plain?
Yes, please.
Decaf or regular?
Decaf, please.
Would you like one of these lovely sticky buns I just took out of the oven?
Oh, yes, please. That looks delicious.
And you Chinaman?
What'd you say?
That was rude. I think she might secretly be racist. Right?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah.
I took a regular coffee and a sticky bun, please.
Okay. And you? She's looking at you, Jeff.
I'll just take a coffee, cream, no sugar.
Would you take a water because you don't have the money?
I thought you were getting this one.
She looks at
coffee or
at Joe. Joe, what would you like?
Can't afford it.
Joe decides to pay for everybody because he's rich.
No, I thought that was Flounder. Trout.
Thank you. Rich, right?
She looks at Trout and she's almost like put out by Trout for some reason. Like, what do you want, son? What do you want?
No self-respecting Texan wouldn't have coffee unless it was black.
All right.
We could put a little milk and sugar in mine too. Well, tequila if you have it.
That doesn't come out till 3.
Oh, so we're legal now, aren't we? me in this
county. You're all legal in this. You're legal for beer and wine
okay.
in the county.
Okay.
Joe Diffie, did you want anything from Mary Lynn? She has black and decaf. She has regular coffee, decaf coffee. It's a fresh sticky bun that just came out of the oven. Did you hear me? Mikey?
Is he frozen up on us?
No, his head's moving.
His head is moving.
Sorry, what's up?
Mary Lynn is offering coffee, regular decaf, and she just has some fresh sticky buns that came out.
Regular, no decaf, because at this point, what's the point if you're drinking coffee? And I'll take three sticky buns.
It's all about the sticky buns. All right, she brings everything over. A couple minutes later, she sits at one little at the biggest table in the place, big wood table, you know. And she puts everything down. She says, "All right, two rules. Don't dirty my books." And she actually gives you some wet wipes because you're eating a sticky bun.
Yes, ma'am.
Is there a picture? We don't have a picture of this one.
You know,
right?
I don't have a picture. I didn't expect you guys to go here.
Oh, okay.
Oh, sorry.
I'm improvising too. It's okay. Fine. We'll see what you find.
I love when we feel like we're on the tracks and we realize we're not. I thought this is where we're being pushed to go to.
I guess it's Hidalgo's then.
I'm on the rails too. I don't know where you're going. I'm just following the car.
That's
all right. Adam's like, hey, nobody does that. So please keep my books clean and the language clean too.
Is that the second rule?
That is second. Just behave yourselves.
Yep.
Pretend your mama's here.
All right, man.
Yes, ma'am.
I like that boy.
He's a good guy, Johnny Moon. Do you know he's a quarterback on the football team?
Isn't he a cornerback?
Well, what's the difference? I really don't know football that way.
One's on offense, one's on defense?
Oh. Yeah. But they both have two syllables.
Really? Tell me about the upcoming season. It turns out she's a huge football fan. And she totally ambushes Johnny Moon.
She's a Texas native.
Yeah, she can't. Johnny Moon can't get a word in.
I'm trying to.
What are the prospects of the team this year? How's the schedule looking? When's your first home game? She just keeps going on and on and on. So.
But Johnny's like, if it was not for football, I would not be playing football today.
I like scrambled eggs. I like eggs over
easy. The coffee is basic coffee. The sticky bun, you know, it's homemade from scratch.
Delicious.
Yeah.
Edison is his.
It's reason enough to come back.
Edison's leg doesn't stop tapping, even though he had decaf. He doesn't have access to a lot of caffeine, and it's doing wonders on the system. Ma'am. How long have you owned the coffee shop?
Oh, the coffee shop's been here a really long time. I just bought about, three, 4 or 5 years ago.
Oh, wow. And have you ever heard of anything strange going around in these parts?
There's a reason this store still stays open. People around here, they do all kinds of crazy things. They're interested in real crazy things. Really? I got a section on occult, demonology, numerology, oils, Reiki. Oh. I'm just going on Amy's list. And she just runs off 20 different topics. Witches, witchcraft, everything.
Did she list the Needler in her list?
No, but I mean, she's talking about all the different things. You know, Native American rituals. She just goes on and on. You don't know how she possibly fits it all in the bookstore.
That's amazing. Do you happen to have anything on the Needler?
Well, that's more of a local thing.
Oh.
You might be better off looking in the paper, the old papers, or sometimes Tony's a good storyteller. Tony Hidalgo, he runs the tractor supply place.
All right.
He has a lot of good stories to tell.
And what do you have on ghosts? Any tips?
Oh, we got a whole section over here on ghosts.
Wow. Is there anything we should watch out for if we ever run into a ghost?
Depends on the kind of ghost.
Oh, there's different kinds.
Yeah, I mean, if there's a free roaming poltergeist or a
full torso vapor separation.
Exactly.
Free floating full torso vapor separation.
So it's like there's Republicans.
That's for Adam.
So it's like there's Republicans and Democrats among the ghost world.
Actually, I think it was Red Bob. I think it went off the table.
Oh.
Off the table.
Off the table entirely.
Off the table by your right foot.
Okay. Oh, got it. Thank you. Now, sir.
So.
Well, I guess we finish off our coffee, and okay. Edison is curious to look at the ghost books. Does he see anything on ghosts? Magic?
I'll look up stuff looking for the needler.
I will look up stuff on rituals.
Okay, so everybody give me an investigation roll.
Okay.
Someday Jeff will get me the water I asked for, too.
I'll get you water, man.
You have an investigation roll. Jeff's too busy playing.
Jeff's got an investigation roll that he's not doing, too.
Yeah, I know.
I'm looking to see if I have an investigation.
The carrot sheets on the table. Please rinse it, though. It has urine.
You got it.
Edison got a 7.
Edison, what were you looking up exactly?
Ghosts.
Ghosts. All right. You find the ghost section. It's a couple bookshelves, maybe about 20 different volumes.
Mm-hmm.
Some look relatively hokey. Some look grounded in fact. You actually find one by Glenn Mack.
How about that? That's cool. Is he one of those professors that makes you buy your own books?
Oh, man.
What did...
I got 8.
What was he looking up?
Rituals.
Ritual, okay.
So we were told to check out the rituals.
Right, so she has a section dedicated to different rituals. Looking through the books, some are... It's gibberish to you. Others seem simple enough that you could perform them, you know, yourself if you want, or with a group of people if you wanted to try. She says, she comes over and notices you. If you're really interested in this one, she pulls out, you know, rituals 101 kind of, people find really interesting. I've heard people that actually had success completing some of these and actually having an effect happen.
Oh, interesting. Neat. Thank you very much.
You sure you're not interested in buying one? I have an extra one.
How much?
Sticker says $5.95.
I'll take it.
You'll take it? I'll wrap it up for you. All right, it's $9 because there's shipping handling. Because there's handling fees. She carried it over to the register for you.
$5 in local pickup fee.
Yeah. All right, so she gives you your book. And
I only got it free.
Coach East found the men's room.
This coffee's really strong.
Coffee's working its way through already, huh?
I ran for the win.
We're waiting for Bobby's in the men's room. Are you guys going to go see Tony next?
I think so.
Do you know where he is? Do you need directions?
That would be helpful.
All right, so she gives you... Adam bought a book on rituals.
Ooh.
Yeah, she suggested the book was she said some people actually had success, claimed to have success with the book. Wow. It's a good intro book. Don't forget there's watermelon up there, boys. Bob brought
it
too.
I'm going to bust it out right now.
And then she offered you directions to Tony because she said she mentioned him and you guys seemed interested. So.
Awesome.
Oh, pre-sliced?
Pre-sliced. Trying to make it easy for you. Should I just... put a couple in a cup for you? Or just walk it over?
Just walk it over. Okay. All right. Joel, Mikey, anything else from you guys?
No. I'm just wandering around trying to get a feel for the place and trying to get a feel for the lady who runs it. Just trying to figure out what her deal is.
If you give me a streetwise check, I'll give you some information.
Okay. Cool.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Jeff, what
a 5.
I do declare I will take 2.
Excellent.
She comes off as pretty upfront and trustworthy. You know, she's not some, you don't think she's some demon lady hiding in the back or anything. Notice that there's a section of books kind of behind a curtain that you're not allowed to get to. There's stairs upstairs, going upstairs. You don't know if she lives up there or what.
Does she look like she could be the type to, like, you know, like lead some of these rituals, or just like she lived the life of, you know, kind of like the Wiccan pagan.
Is she Ruth? Kinda. No.
No.
Is her theme song "I Put a Spell on You"? Does that every time she walks into a room?
you don't think that she's in depth with it. She seems to have a general knowledge of all of them. You know, she has some crystals. She has all. She can talk the talk. You don't know necessarily she can walk the walk.
Okay.
She can sell the book.
Yes. I mean, she does run a business.
Yeah, sure, sure. There's a difference between running a business and being the business.
Yes. Being your own best customer.
Exactly.
And she has some of the funny things in a display case. You like looking into the restricted section. We'll call it restricted.
There's no like Eye of Newt and.
Well, there's a case that you can't make out what's in it.
Right.
I'm picturing a cross between Giles' shop and the library in Harry Potter.
That's not a bad description, but you can't really see that well. I mean, you don't want to stare. There's a curtain drawn over.
Yeah.
You know, you walk past, you can kind of look through the crack as you slow down gingerly. You know, it's like when Jeff walks through the hall and looks at girls in yoga.
I have no problem walking up and asking her what's behind there, or what's the deal with that.
Well, that's for the.
What's up with that?
That is for the my special customers. Those who you know really believe in what we teach and talk about, and not just here to mock us or to, you know, a college student who just thinks this might be interesting. You know, if you keep coming around and we have some nice conversations, and I start to you know get to know you guys real well, I'll be happy to invite you back there. By the way, what was your name again?
My name's Joe, and I'm going to tell you, since I've been here, which has only been a couple days, this place has
been
weirdest, strangest place I have ever been.
Pinebox is known for its specialness.
You call it specialness? Right now, I'm not really sure what to call it.
Yeah, we have some stuff here. We have
a lot of
interesting history.
My friends seem to think that there's this crazy creature running around. I haven't seen it or anything of it yet. But I'll tell you right now, since what happened up at the Roost and what happened during the scavenger hunt the other night, I'm starting to believe that we are in a weird place.
Pinebox does seem to be the center of some people call it a supernatural nexus.
Is there a convergence of ley lines?
I'm gonna stick with some weird shit for right now, and we'll work on the supernatural nexus part later.
Okay. I've got some books on ley lines over here if you'd like to read them.
I would love to read them.
Okay. Well, Adam mentioned it, so she mentioned Wan Lo. They're right here.
Do you have any Native American folklore?
I have some Native American rituals and folklore right over here in this section. It's kind of small, because in that case, I'll just refer you to your school library, because they have a very extensive section. Mm-hmm.
Do you know if there's a lot of pet stores in Pinebox?
Not really any pet stores.
It just strikes me that if you wanted to make a fortune, you could sell books and pets, because something keeps killing all the pets. So you could just keep on supplying people with new pets. Hey!
This is Texas.
Don't talk about that.
We just have dogs and cats all over the place.
Oh, all right. Go to any barn
by the area?
We have litters all over the place.
All right. I understand. Well, thank you very much for your hospitality, man.
Oh, please come back soon. And what was your name again, young man?
My name is Edison.
Okay, Edison. And you are?
Wan Lo.
Yeah, that's not a name I'm going to forget, because it's different.
If you do, it's okay to ask again.
Okay, and what was your name?
Johnny Moon.
Johnny Moon. Yeah. Wildly, I'll be looking for you in the sports page.
I hope I don't disappoint you.
And your name was Joe?
Joe Diffie.
Joe Diffie. I don't know if I can remember that. Joe's a pretty common name. What was your name?
Strange.
That's right. You'll just remember me by my charm and my good looks.
Definitely by your hair. And she looks at Trout and is like, what was your name?
Oh, I'm Elmer. Oh, I'm Trout, and it's nice to meet you.
Elmer? Like the glue?
I think we all just call him Trout. He prefers it.
So
he's kind of thick like the glue, at least.
So glue or fish? Why? Okay, son, your parents fish. Did you a heap of specialists there.
All you can think of is Uncle Elmer from wrestling in the 80s.
All right, so you guys are heading out to, what's your next stop?
Joe Hidalgo. Tony Hidalgo. At Hidalgo's Wares and Tractors.
Yep.
The town historian who will talk our ears off.
Yes, sir.
By the way, Wan Lo, is there anything in that book of rituals? I mean, what do they say?
Yeah, it's rituals.
Hey, Wan Lo, is that a book?
He doesn't have a lot of time to look at it. Right. I mean, there's some basic ones, enchant something with the ability to glow light.
And the one ritual where it says, you lay on the ground,
yes.
And you say, you get your friends around you,
yeah.
They put one finger on you.
Fascinating.
And they're supposed to lift you up with one finger.
Yeah.
But you have to say, light as a feather, stiff as a board. Light as a feather, stiff as a board. And keep repeating it. And
light
lift somebody up.
All right. Okay.
What is
that
from?
Ritual. That's like what you do at a sleepover.
Yeah.
Like girls do that at slumber parties or something.
Who are they wearing?
And then they bust out the Ouija board, which always kills me because the Ouija board, which enables you to talk to the dead, is produced by Milton Bradley, maker of Battleship. Like, it's just so weird to me. Do you want to sink a ship or commune with your dead uncle? What would you like to do today, son?
All right, so you guys head on over to the...
Sounds a little more realistic.
You guys have...
How did that kid cut off his finger? Did he ever tell you how he did it?
Oh, yeah, yeah, he had shears.
Like, pruning shears?
Like wire cutter shears?
Okay.
All right, so you guys head on over.
Is this a real thing?
No, this is a real thing. It's a conversation we
had.
This is
not
a
real
call
I had a while back.
Manscaped?
His pinky.
You know?
His girlfriend was going to break up with him, so he thought if he cut off his finger, she wouldn't break up with him. So then we showed up, and then the paramedic came, and he's crying, and she says, what's going on? She said, I cut off my finger. She says, why? She says, because my girlfriend's going to break up with me. The paramedic says, how's that working out for you? And he says, not good.
Bob found the finger.
Yeah, it was fun.
Did you take it and flip somebody? Flip it at somebody?
Here, I'll give you the finger.
That would have been funny.
All right, so you find sort of on the outskirts of town, Tony Hidalgo's hardware store and tractor supply. You know, you got to watch where you're walking. Tractors are driving back and forth. There's forklifts with stuff.
So you're like trails of manure.
No, but it's kind of like as close as they get at the Home Depot.
So he's got a black and white striped button-down shirt and a giant 10-gallon white ivory hat. And who was that actor? Is that an actor that we know?
No, that's Texas Cowboy.
Texas Cowboy. He almost reminds me of the upstairs landlord from Three's Company. Not Don Knotts, but the other guy.
Actually, I was going to say he kind of looked like Mr. Drummond a little bit, too.
Oh, Mr. Drummond. Yeah.
He looks like close to something, but I couldn't put my finger on it.
He's got like the hint of a smile, almost.
Yeah.
I know.
So there's people scurrying all over the place. Some kid comes up to you. What do you guys need here today? Please be careful walking around because there's a lot of activity. We got a couple of big orders going out.
Hi. We're here to talk to Mr. Hidalgo.
And this is regarding?
Local folklore.
Oh.
Oh boy.
He takes out his walkie-talkie. Tony, we got a couple guys that want to talk to you up here.
He a big talker?
And you can, he has a little earpiece. Mm. Yeah, they have some folklore questions. Guy comes like running around the corner.
I guess it won't be a problem to get his attention.
Looks like you got it now.
And he comes up, he's shaking everything. How you doing, son? He comes up to Ed and says, wow, you don't look like you're from around here. How you doing? I'm Tony.
Ow, my hand. Ow.
Arms going up and down.
You hear bones crunching because don't forget Edison's strength is D4. His endurance is D4. So it's a very strong grip and it's crushing his hand.
Hi there. Hi. Please don't hurt me.
What was your name?
Edison, sir.
Edison. Well, hi. And he's. What's your name?
Wang Montgomery.
What?
Juan Lo Montgomery.
What the? Nice. What's your
Johnny Moon, sir?
He's not from around here, sir.
Johnny, okay. And he turns to Joe Diffie, shakes his hand. What's your name, son?
My name's Joe.
Dude, I like your hair. Do you wear a hat at night or something and then pull it up like that? So it sticks
up
like that?
This is just an extra hair gel. That's all.
Gel.
Jail, sir. Yeah.
Hair jail.
What's that?
It's very common these days.
You put your hair in jail?
Do you remember? You remember back in the day when you used to use Pall Mall, like in the days of Fonzie and grease.
Bro cream.
It's like that.
You mean like when I used that wax stick to make this?
Yeah, it's a modern day version of a wax stick, sir.
Yeah. Cost more.
He barely even acknowledges Trout.
Hey.
Locals do not.
Yeah. Okay, I don't know why. There's something going on with Trout today.
Yeah.
Relax him.
Last time we were in town, everybody liked him just fine, except for when he pulled the fire alarm.
Well, he should brush his teeth a bit more.
That's true.
Yeah.
I'll do the plan.
Son, you're a cow?
I'm beginning to think that maybe Trout's family and the drilling of the wells has something to do with maybe the evil spirits that are going on in this town.
So I heard you guys want to talk about some local history.
Yes, sir, we do.
Did you know that there was a sinkhole under the police station like 30 years ago? The whole police station sank in there, and they just built a new one right on top.
Golly. Was anybody killed?
No. But it was exciting.
Oh, my gosh. Have you heard anything about ghosts up at the Roost?
Ghosts at the Roost? Yeah, no, I heard that place burned down.
Oh, we were talking
about... Wait, did I see your pictures in the paper? Were you there?
I think you might have seen us, yes, sir.
Tell me the story so I can remember, so I can tell other people what happened.
Oh, well, I think Joe Diffie tells it pretty well. Maybe he should tell us. Huh?
Guy, can you tell the story for me, man?
I don't mind picking on that as much.
You're right.
Joe Diffie, can you tell me the story?
Unmuted?
Yeah, I can certainly tell you the story, but it's uneventful because these guys seem to think that they saw something crazy, and then the next thing you know, the place is on fire and everybody's running out screaming.
Wait a minute, you saw something crazy in Pinebox?
Yes, sir.
Everything in Pinebox seems to be crazy, Tony, or Mr. Hidalgo.
You can call me Tony.
Is it okay if I call you Tony?
Everybody calls me Tony.
Tony, I'm going to tell you right now, since I've been here, everything has been strange.
Where are you from? Fat Tony.
Just up the road a piece.
I don't know if you'd fit in Texas.
But nowhere like from where this town is. This town is... I mean, since we've been here, we almost got locked in a room. The guards, these guys keep seeing some sort of hairy thing with spikes coming out of it.
Ooh, the needler.
Yeah, I think we saw the needler, sir.
Wait a minute, you know about this needler thing, too?
You saw it and you're alive?
Well, Johnny,
we saw the needler. It took it came out the wall. Something came out the wall with the spikes on it. Hard to see it. And it grabbed a security guard who was trying to lock everybody in and dragged him into the wall. We never see him again.
That's crazy talk.
And they still haven't found that security.
Well, what are you smoking?
That's like
you
telling us, Tony. They're all crazy.
No, I was not smoking that night. Joe was smoking. I was not smoking anything.
But Joe don't believe.
Joe didn't see that happen. Joe was trying to help people get out the one door that worked.
Oh, Joe's Dana Scully. Got it.
Coochie's here. He saw it, and he saw something else a few weeks ago.
Really? Can you describe it to me?
I go through the description that I just gave Dr.
So wow, was that a slacker response? Sure.
Well, the first time I saw it, it looked like it just came out of the wall.
Really?
And it stayed as part of the wall and grabbed the security guard and dashed him down the...
Yeah, it was like the wall come alive, but like you could see the outline with the spikes.
That's crazy.
It's like 5'8", like 6 foot almost, somewhere between like 5'10", 6 foot, like it big.
Somewhere between 5 foot and 6 foot.
And I was like, hold on, guys, give me some slack.
Then I saw it on the scavenger night.
Where'd you see it?
I saw it in the alleyway between down the street from the pizza place.
Yeah, there was a dead cat there that night.
We saw that cat get killed.
Or we heard the cat get killed.
Well, yeah, then we found the body.
Yeah.
And I took the corner and I
poor,
saw...
Poor old Nellie, she's all busted up about that cat being killed like that.
So it looked like, I guess, what you guys call the needler.
If only somebody opened up a pet shop in town, they could make a killing.
Why? If you want a cat, you go see old lady out there. She got litter
cats. Old lady, lots of cats.
Oh yeah, old lady, lots of cats.
Are you thinking what I'm thinking? The old lady
of
down
course,
the street.
But where are we going to get a pair of women's underwear at this time of night, Brain?
That's not what I'm thinking, Pinky. I'm thinking that the old lady down the street with the cats is dressing up in costume, killing all the cats so that she can get more business when people come and buy more cats from her.
She gives them away.
Oh, all right, then
Does she own a pet food company?
A pet food company, yeah. Is there a pet food store in town?
No, she's just a crazy old cat lady.
Oh, all right. See, I saw a movie once. It said, Follow the Money. That's how I'm pretty good at investigating, but usually it's on the internet.
Usually they don't have a lot of clothes, but I'm very good at investigating and follow the money, so I was just thinking maybe we follow the money and we could solve this needler problem. Guess not.
Listen, I've been investigating a needler for a long time.
Really?
Yep. Some people swear that it's a chupacabra, because those things supposedly, you know, hide and never be seen. But that's like a giant dog.
Oh.
Or wolf or something.
Legs?
Yeah, and then he's telling me something on two legs.
So chupacabra's got, it walks like a dog.
Yeah, well, I've never seen a chupacabra.
So how do we know it walks on two legs?
Yeah, chupacabra's a legendary creature.
Oh, I see. So there is some doubt over the origin of this creature or both.
Yeah, I think it's just people tying knots together, trying to link together things they don't understand.
Let's see.
So wait a minute, Tony, are you saying that this needler thing is real and the chupacabra is just a fictional thing?
I'm saying there's a lot of unexplained stuff here. There's a lot of reports describing something spiky, but nobody's ever seen anything for real. And there's a lot of unexplained stuff like old Nellie's cat. I mean, who's gonna kill an old lady's cat? I mean, that's why we don't have a Chinese food restaurant. We chased them out of town because they kept going to see the old lady at the cat's place and she couldn't keep up.
That was out of character, by the way. Just saying. Wait, 1 minute said that. For one low. I am offended.
But that thing was ripped to shreds. I saw it. No, even stupid college kids wouldn't do that.
Well, that's true.
What about some of the locals?
No, nobody's going to mean the old Nellie.
Did he let you go after all animals? Or is it cows and cats?
Cats, dogs.
Okay, so not everything we can see.
No. There was an incident a few years ago where about three or four cows were killed over the course of a month and a half.
I read about you in the paper. It said that you were doing some investigation into the cattle killing.
I did. Didn't find much.
You don't look very different from a couple of years ago. You age well, sir.
Well, thank you. Good Texas living. Grits and beef.
Did they ever solve it?
Brisket and what?
So they never figured out what or who killed the cattle?
No, not a clue.
Wow. Brisket braised brisket?
Pork is special. Usually it's brisket.
Well, you got any advice for newcomers to town? You seem to know a lot about it. Any things we should watch out for or be careful of?
I say always travel in pairs.
Oh.
You know, that makes sense anytime.
Mm-hmm.
You know, be gentlemen. Make sure you walk those ladies home.
Yes, sir.
Because that's what gentlemen do.
Yes, sir. You post it in their bedroom. Oh, sorry.
You keep it in your pocket, son. But if you're going to take it out, make sure you're wearing a glove.
Never leave
your soldier in the battle without his helmet.
We'll talk about it later.
I don't understand. What did he mean? All right. Okay.
You don't have to worry about it.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay.
You hear somebody talking to him on his earpiece. Is there anything else I can do for you, fellas?
Well, we are just doing some investigation. You got any tips on where we might investigate next?
Well, you're from the university. Did you talk to that Glenn Mack guy? Because he did a lot of digging, too.
Yes, sir. He suggested we talk to you.
And we also talked to Nellie at the bookstore.
Old Marilyn.
Marilyn at the bookstore.
Yep, she's a sweetheart.
Oh, she's
great coffee. Great coffee. Her sticky buns are okay. You guys are the exact opposite.
Oh.
And the only other person
to
mention.
Where are you going to get good sticky buns? Because if there's something better than that, I want to know about.
Well, you got to make your own then.
Oh. Okay, I see.
Or you get the Pillsbury can. You know, when you pop open, you put that in the oven. Obviously, his taste buds suck.
Yeah. I'm trying to think of an appropriate way to respond.
He puts a big cigar in his mouth.
I understand. Thank you.
And what do you know about Paul Vanderhorn? Is he a guy that we should talk to, sir?
I don't know if he can help you with this stuff. I mean, if you're looking for like hand weapons and stuff like that, or you need an engine fixed, he's your man. That guy's a whiz with mechanical stuff.
He is the engine, right?
Does he have anything that can hurt a needler or a ghost?
Well, we don't know what would hurt a needler or a ghost because we've never seen one.
Oh. Have you seen anything strange in all your time here aside from the sinkhole?
Oh, sure, all kinds of stuff. I've been out to the burn a couple times. Been out to...
To the burn?
You guys don't know about the burn yet?
Oh,
no, sir.
But
What is the burn, sir?
Burn.
Let me see if there's an actual description on here.
You guys know that I'm taking notes here. Like, when next time my niece and nephew come to sleep over, they're like, Uncle Bob, what can we do this weekend? I'll be like, well, we can go out to the burn, but, you know, people have been lost there. Or, you know, there's rumors that there's the Needler.
The never-ending forest.
What's the farthest you can go into a forest?
Well, I think I know the answer.
Yeah, back in 1953.
Halfway.
Back in 1953, there was an area forest east of here that had a fire. And we can never figure out what caused it. But it's 60 years later, and there's still 2 square miles of forest. Nothing has grown there.
What?
Nothing.
That's physical.
Blackened and lifeless as the day after the fire.
Was it a chemical explosion of some sort? Some sort of toxic gases that salted the earth?
60 years ago, I wasn't there.
Wow.
But I've been out to the burn. It's disturbing.
Wow. You ever see anything strange at the burn? Aside from the trees not growing and the desolate wasteland of a black, bleary landscape causing you to question your own...
It's just that I wouldn't go out there at night.
Yes, sir. Guys, I have a great idea.
Let's go get a cat and take it to the burn at night and catch the needle.
Let's go to the burn at night. Yes, exactly.
Your buddy Glenn Mack, he's gone out there a few times too.
Oh, all right. What do you say? Get a picture, make some money.
Is there a relation between the needle and the burn?
Not that I'm aware of. Usually the needle's closer to town or closer to the university. I will tell you the burn is not related to tonight. It's just a piece of information for later on. All
right, okay.
I'm not giving you any more hooks like that.
How many people do you think have come across the Needler?
And live to tell the tale, you mean, John and Moon?
You know, the Needler's never, there's no record of the Needler killing a person. At least not tearing one up, maybe from fright, but never killing one, tearing them up, shredding them. It's always smaller animals or more defenseless animals.
Well, we saw it grab that security guard.
Yeah, but we don't know if he didn't kill it. Then we know.
So does that mean he's alive somewhere? Trapped?
Or there's just no evidence that he's dead.
Mm. He's like the anti-PETA. He like hates animals but saves humans.
Well, let's not go into that too much.
All right.
It does run kill animal shelters.
Oh, it does?
Yeah,
So, guys, I gotta go. Still got something. Is there anything else I can help you? Please come back. I'd love to talk to you.
Well, nice meeting you, sir. Thank you very much.
If you want, we can meet over coffee at Mary Lynn's one time. If you got any more, we need some more history.
That would be great.
We let you know.
Here's my card.
All right.
Email is an easy way to get me. All
right. Oh, good.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, maybe an old Texan, but I'm not that old.
I'll send you a Google link to hair jail so you can learn all about it.
We're high school, just out of high school kids. What's the email?
Oh, yeah, that's a good point.
That's a great point.
That's what you use to sign up for Twitter and Vine.
That's fine.
Well done.
Jules just signed up for Twitter. Jules just got her own Twitter account.
Oh, really? Well, I was going to say, I should friend her. No, I shouldn't. No, I shouldn't.
So, sir, do you have a Snapchat account then? No, not so much. Instagram? No.
I have an email address.
All right. Okay. Are you using AOL to connect to your email address?
How many minutes a month do you get?
Yeah. Why? What's wrong with AOL?
Nothing wrong. There's 2.1 million people right now in 2015 still using AOL to connect to the internet. That's very honorable.
That's because those 2.1 million people are just lazy.
That is a true stat, by the way.
They're all in Eastern Texas.
I actually know some people.
I have a friend.
Yeah.
As well.
John Fragasini, Joel, still has an AOL address.
Billy Howard.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. And I have a psychology professor who used to volunteer.
Yeah.
Even at work, I still see AOL.
Halfway out to the internet.
It's, you know what it's like? It's like your phone number.
Yeah, I mean, once you have it for so long.
Yeah.
And now it's just a portal.
Yeah.
Since you don't have to pay for it anymore if you don't have AOL internet access?
You might have to pay a little bit for the portal.
Critical issues for me.
All right.
Sorry, Tony. Thank you very much, sir.
Oh, it was nice to meet you boys.
And you.
Well, four of you at least.
Well. What time is it now?
Flunch time. Yeah, flunch time now.
Okay.
Hey, guys. Anybody get the free pizza yet this week? We still got pizza we can have?
I haven't gotten mine.
That's what we're going to have of ours.
Let's go get some pizza.
Okay.
Pizza.
we put some broccoli out there for you.
You guys order meat lovers all the time. I just like to see a speck of green. Just a little green.
How about we put some basil on it this time?
What was that, Joe?
We'll get you some green. We'll put some basil on it.
Basil.
They have the oregano on the table. You put oregano on there.
One green pepper.
Okay. All right. Let's go. Sure. I'll take something better than nothing.
Some old sausage.
So what do you want to do?
All right. So you guys get to the pizza barn.
Yeah.
Settle in. You have your. They recognize you now. They know you by name.
Do they have the pizza? Like they put the pizza in as soon as they see us without asking?
Not that far yet.
Okay.
You mixed it up a little bit. You know, sometimes you leave the ham off.
Oh, okay.
So, Joe, John and Moon, how did you meet Missy anyways? I see you guys seem to be good friends these days.
He's in one of my my English lit class.
And if you don't mind me asking, how
did it look like you guys studied Latin?
What do you mean by that, Juan? I don't understand.
You don't have to worry about
it. It's English lit, probably. So just say it. It was
English lit class. I have to say this. So I sent out the email about the nightmares. Jeff responds, "That about that? Am I waking up alone?"
What's she wearing?
To which I respond, "You tell me."
Then he said, "We'll have to roll for it."
Yeah, I said roll for it. And later on, I said, "Go ahead."
So Joe Diffie, Donna Moon. I mean, you guys seem to have a way with the women. I mean, what's your best pickup line? Are you so confident among them? It's like so hard to talk. I just start stammering all the time.
You just talk to them and listen to them. It's not hard.
It's very hard. How do your palm, my palms sweat, and I start stammering. I can't even think of a word in my head.
It still happens to Adam.
What are you talking about?
Edison. This is how you just gotta pretend like you're interested in what they're talking about.
All right.
I mean, you're a freaking brainiac. They're not going to understand a damn thing you're talking about anyway. So your best bet is just to get them talking about themselves and just nod, because as soon as you open your mouth, you're going to screw it up.
All right. Well, previous history is an indication of future performance, and you are exactly right. So every time I open my mouth, I screw it up.
It better to let people think you're a fool than open your mouth and remove any doubt.
So listen, your best bet is to not say too much. Let them get talking. They'll think you're sweet because you're listening to them.
All right.
Every once in a while, just kind of nod your head.
Okay.
Like you understand what they're talking about, and mm-hmm. say, "Oh, I totally understand."
I totally understand. Thank you.
See, there you go. See how easy that is?
That was good. Thank you, sir.
Then in the morning, just kick them out, because there'll be another one the next day.
Well, that's not very nice. Why would I do that? Wait, why are they at my house? Don't they have a place to sleep?
Oh, dear, dear God. You know, if the needler comes, Edison, I'm going to feed you to it.
Oh, that's a rude thing to say.
Dude, he's a special 98-pound weakling. He's not big enough for the needler to eat.
I'm just thinking it'll buy Johnny and I a few minutes to get away.
Well, let's hope we never run into that situation, because that sounds pretty drastic. If we all have to run for it, I'm going to be behind all of you.
I'm just saying, your best bet with the women is to do as little as little talking as possible.
He should be somebody's wingman.
I don't know if you really want him as a wingman.
Listen, I'm an excellent wingman. I'll have you know that I played Twilight 2000, and I take the Interceptor 5-7, and I can pin off the tail on a donkey at 15 parsecs. I am good as a wingman. I'll protect my partner.
15 parsecs? Isn't that how long it took us to do the castle run? I thought it was 12.
Edison, if you say parsecs to a woman,
yeah,
she's going to get up and walk away.
Oh.
You smoke.
Unless you're talking about sex in a park.
So perhaps light years would be better, right? Since parsec isn't truly a measurement of distance, it was just fabricated.
I'd stay away from the light years as well.
Oh, all right. Okay. Well, then, I'll just I'll just say, hi, how are you?
Exactly. Get them, like I said, just get them talking about themselves and just nod and say, I totally understand.
So there's a girl over there. I could go talk to her right now.
I say you give it a shot. She's one of the Omega Moos. You got a good shot with that one.
Okay.
Say, hey, what do you think about, I don't know, make a topic. What do you think about, and that get them talking.
Okay. All right. I'll go do that. So Edison is going to go approach the girl in the side of the pizza parlor.
Did you just check
Juan Lo. Hey, Juan Lo, you
can check work.
Ha, what's that, Joe?
Juan Lo, videotape this. This is going to be a stare. We put this on YouTube. We're going to make enough money where we don't got to worry about, you know, jobs while we're at college.
Okay, so Edison walks up to a table.
I'm totally filming this.
There's a young lady there. There's a pizza. There's two plates, which he hasn't noticed yet.
Edison is already feeling the sweats begin. His leg is shaking. His hands are shaking. His mouth has gone dry. He's finding it very difficult to even speak, but he makes a Herculean effort, and he says,
what do you talk to humans about? Hi.
Excuse me?
Oh, God. Sorry. And he takes off back to the table.
And he's met with peals of laughter.
about a minute later, as they're finishing their chuckles, a gargantuan guy walks out of the men's room, sits down, and gets back to talking about her, talking to her. Obviously, they're together. She points over your direction.
Edison waves enthusiastically. Hi. Was that good, Joe? I didn't do good.
You
okay? No.
I'm gonna say, Edison, that on a scale of 1 to 10.
Yeah.
That was a -12.
Oh. That's
you keep practicing.
I will.
But you know what? You know what? Ancient Chinese proverbs say, "Practice make perfect."
I need a lot of practice, Dan.
Juan Lo, is that the right proverb?
Yeah, sure, Joe. That's it. Yeah.
I mean, as a Chinaman, you ought to know that that's the right proverb, right?
I resent that. That is a stereotype. Joe lived in Houston before he came up here. He may know nothing about proverbs.
I spent a lot of time in China. I grew up in China.
Hey, proverbs is part of the Old Testament, isn't it?
Oh! He's super religious. That's true.
I know proverbs. I know... I don't read the Bible much, but I know about it. I had to talk about it, but I never actually read it.
I don't know much about it. I slept through that part of Sunday school.
I mean, I know the story of Joel, but I know the story of Abraham.
You
Pope
mean
Jeff,
John,
he's got work
right?
to do now.
You mean John?
Huh?
Pope Jeff, he's got to get you guys on the rails.
All right.
Not exactly sure where the rails are, by the way.
I'm waiting for Jeff to get you back on them.
Oh, okay.
that's my work. That was just a great little, I believe it's called an interlude.
Yes. That was
and it just came out totally naturally.
That's fine. That's what you're here upon for. So back to you've eaten your pizza now. You've embarrassed Edison a little further.
well, guys, I've got
to so, I'll make it easy for you. The waiter comes back. So what are you fellas up to today anyway? We're seeing you here in the middle of a Thursday. It's not too common.
Getting ready for finals. Midterms.
We are also looking for the needler. Edison blurts it out.
Edison, for God's sakes, why?
Yeah, we're looking for any proof of the needler anywhere.
This is crazy talk.
What?
It's just crazy.
Really? You sound like you know something.
He couldn't be any more crazier, trust me.
I'm not crazy. I heard it, and he saw it with his own eyes. He points at Johnny.
Oh, really?
Saw something really crazy looking.
Hey, guys!
Did you see the needler?
There's some chuckles from behind the counter.
Would the needler rip a cat in two? There was a cat ripped in two in the alleyway.
At this point, Joe is looking around for any table with anybody he knows that he could possibly get up and go over to.
Joe is looking for the escape exit.
Exactly.
Release the escape pods.
Joe turns to Edison and says, we are not talking about this again.
Well,
In public, at least.
There's some money involved. I mean, don't you at least be curious?
Edison, if there's money involved, we don't need to let everybody know about it.
Well, look, they don't believe in it, clearly. Aren't you a little bit curious about this mysterious thing?
I didn't say I'm not curious about it, but why do we need to bring extra attention to ourselves?
Oh, well, you just asked a question. Sometimes I feel compelled to answer questions. That's all.
He didn't ask you a question. He asked a question, and he didn't ask you that, like, for your life history.
He asked what we were looking for. We were looking for the Needler.
Some pizza.
Well, Needler and pizza. We already got the pizza, so that just leaves the Needler.
We could have just said we were taking a break from class.
But that's not true. We were looking for the Needler.
Well, no, it's true. Are we in class right now? No, we're taking a break.
Hey, let's go take a look. We're here. We're just finishing in, right?
Yeah.
Let's go walk by that alleyway.
You want to go back there?
Yeah.
What if it's there?
It's the daytime. We're okay.
Yeah, you think?
Okay, so there. If we'll take a step back for a second. There were two incidents with the Needler that night. The first one, you didn't see anything. You just sort of cat.
That's right.
And the second one where you fumbled your cell phone and Cochise got a sight. Was it actually a dog?
No, it was a dog that got ripped out.
Yeah.
The dog one was closer, I believe.
The dog one was the one where you caught your glimpse, and that was closer, yes.
Okay.
Let's go over there.
All right. Sounds good.
So you guys are walking out, and Dwayne is walking in. You'll recall Dwayne was your sixth man during the scavenger hunt.
The local who didn't work.
He was cool.
Did he get free pizza from that?
Yeah.
Oh! Freaking freeloader.
Guys, what's up?
Hey, Dwayne, how are you? We're looking for the Needler. You want to come?
Are you going to finish that last piece of pizza?
I'm not.
Hey.
What?
Hey, I got an idea for the rest of the night, Edison.
What's that, Joe?
How about we don't mention the Needler for the rest of the night to anybody? We just go about our business looking for it.
What if? All right, but what if it's like right behind you and I have to say, Joe, you have to turn around because the Needler is about to kill you.
Is this like the quiet game? Except it's like a topic?
I'm good at quiet game. I'm thinking, Edison, if you just clap your hands 3 times, I'll know what it means.
So you want, like, a secret code so the Needler doesn't know?
Exactly. If we say the Needler's right behind us, then it's going to disappear into the shadows again.
Oh, all
right. If we don't talk about it anywhere to anyone,
okay.
And if anyone sees it, they just clap 3 times,
all right.
Then we'll all know, and it won't know that we're looking for it.
Why would it – if it approaches us about to kill us and it sees me clap 3 times, don't you think it would find that very suspicious?
If it's about to kill us, does it care that it's suspicious?
Well, then maybe it's okay if I shout out, watch out, Needler's gonna kill you! No, we can try it. We can try the code. I like it. We can try that.
I assume this discussion is happening as you're walking toward the alley.
Yes.
Quietly.
I say we give this a try. Does Edison have a drink with him?
He didn't break the law. He doesn't take drinks out of the pizza establishment, so he does not have a drink.
Do you have a water bottle with you?
Oh, yeah, I guess connected to a backpack. Sure.
All right, Joe accidentally bumps into Edison and grabs his water bottle.
Edison is completely oblivious.
Joel, did you have something to say before? You were muting and not muting. It looked like you were going to say something.
Oh, I just thought I was going to lose my pizza.
Oh, don't you worry, Trout. We made sure that you got that last slice.
Okay.
Yeah, Dwayne was a little put out, but, you know.
Dwayne has his own pizza.
He has his own pizza. You think?
If you use it this week, not our
pizza. While we're walking, Joe opens up Edison's water bottle and crushes up a little white pill that he has in his pocket into the bottle. And as we're walking, I get Johnny to shove me into Edison again, and I drop the water bottle back in his pack.
Oh, careful there.
Sorry about that. Johnny's playing games again, Edison. I apologize.
Johnny,
man, it's pretty damn hot here. It's pretty damn hot here in Texas, man. We should all be making sure we stay hydrated.
Yeah, you're right,
Edison,
Johnny. This is
you
not
evolved.
A I mean,
you're like 98 pounds, man. If you sweat more than like 2 minutes, you're gonna shrivel up to nothing.
I guess you're right. I am feeling a little parched now that you mention it. Takes his water bottle, takes a great big swig, then he like pours a portion over his head, then he takes another swig and then he caps it up. Ah, refreshing.
What was in the bottle? What is he feeling?
You gotta make a bigger check. See if you've got enough in.
Well, he's not gonna survive that bigger check.
All right.
Possibly
the
untrained vicar.
He's got a four. Oh, I guess that's a... So you succeeded. You. What'd you give him? Something to make him sleepy?
Yeah, like a Valium.
So you're a little cooler.
Okay.
That's all. You get to the alley. I mean, it's been a couple of weeks since you were there. So you want to roll notice checks or whatever? Okay.
Investigation maybe or something?
The same investigation, I consider more of a researchy thing. Okay. Notice is more like you're looking for something.
I rolled an 11 on my notice. I noticed the shadow that the needler left on the wall.
Jeff just keeps rolling this die over and over again.
We all did well. I did all right, too. Not as well as him. I did 10.
Did you go for a record tonight?
Wait,
29.
29?
Rolled 3 8s in a row.
That's amazing. Your notice is D8? At first level? That's amazing as well.
Wadlow doesn't even notice.
You know what? That roll was so good, he smells the fart that the needler left in the alley from 4 days ago.
Hey, Trav, by the way, I thought you were friends with the woman at the coffee house, but she doesn't seem to really take a liking to you today.
I'm friends with the lady at the taco house.
Oh, all right.
Yeah, mom's chili bar. That's where you're fitting. Right. Pretty
guys,
well.
We should go get chili.
But we just ate. We just had pizza.
But we're on the way home.
Huh.
I guess I'm a Tom of chili.
I could do chili. Oh, I feel pretty good right now.
Mon, no, that Tom of chili no good for me, man.
All right, so you guys.
I dubbed your Tom of chili. Reminds me of home.
You guys crawl through the alley looking for information. Coach East is outstanding role, just dwarfs anything you guys, he pulls out his magnifying glass, he's Sherlock Holmes.
Coach East is standing in the building, he sees little mouse poop.
I'll let him out. Yeah.
Coach East solves like 3 outstanding cold case mysteries.
Yeah. This call detective
blank. Doesn't look normal.
This is not a native flea.
There isn't a ton to find. You do find several other, we'll call it rodent corpses, picked fairly clean. Most people wouldn't notice that from the perspective of who cares. It's garbage cans. There's nothing terribly exciting. I mean, it has been a couple weeks, It's
a good thing you wasted that role.
No other big corpses? Like no dogs or...
Nah, it's the middle of the day, so anything that would happen.
What types of wounds are on the dead rats? Are they slash marks or... No visible...
More like it's just chewed up.
Okay.
Bites taken out of it.
The marrow sucked out of the cracked bones.
Sure.
Not often you say sure to that question. I just want to... It's only a game
the bones
night.
Are ground up to make bread.
Only during game night does somebody say, was the marrow sucked out of cracked bones, and you nonchalantly answer,
yeah, sure.
Well, what now, Johnny Moon? Do you think we've got any more proof? We got a couple of dead rats.
I don't know. Who has class tomorrow? Anybody?
I've got class.
Yeah, French term probably all have class.
I got programming in Fortran.
By the way, you know the eraser backwards.
What's that?
The eraser backwards. It's not X, Y, it's Y, X.
Yeah, that's right. Annoying.
What time are you guys done tomorrow?
I'm done by 2.
I finish at 2:30.
I think maybe we go up and visit my abuelita.
Spanish? I need to wait a minute.
Is that like a sweat lodge thing? Are we going to commune with the spirits?
She is a spirit guide. She's a medicine woman spirit guide from the.
I am all over this one.
Really, you don't? I have a picture you don't want to be.
Maybe I skip out on that one. It's not like enough for me.
Wang Lo, you gotta meet his family. For goodness sake, we all just survived opening freshman night. We're all like family right now. And I'll tell you, I feel good.
Have
I
you
just
ever
want
been
you
to
all
Northern
to know.
Texas?
No.
See, I love you, all of you right now. I just feel the love. I feel really good.
I don't have a problem with your family, but I don't want
to
talk
to you. We work hard to put food on our family.
And then you eat it off your family? But you know, communing with spirits, it sounds, it's only one spirit. You can't commune
with Johnny,
spirits.
Is there going to be any peyote involved in this?
maybe that's who she's communing with.
There may be, Mikey. And
I'm thinking I'm in on this one.
In my research of this, which was brief but somewhat interesting, a lot of Native Americans are actually Catholic and such.
Now.
Well, no, but they're both. I mean, they follow
a
Christian belief system, but they still
work
with spirits.
Although, I guess you could argue that that still kind of happens even among people who aren't Native Americans. How many people do you know that take the statue of St. Joseph and bury it upside down in their lawn?
Oh, to try to sell the house?
Sell the house.
My parents actually did that.
My parents did too, because it was like a...
It didn't work.
You're Jewish!
They had a week left to sell the house, and they were desperate, and it worked.
Did they convert after that?
They're like Simpsons. They're more like the level of Simpsons religion. But I guess my point is that these weird rituals are followed by other groups that claim to be
even Christianity co-opted other religions.
Oh, reading the horoscope.
Reading the horoscope.
Yeah.
Whoa, my mom in Houston, Mrs. Montgomery, she knows the horoscope.
All right, so you got to.
We can go. I never thought about it. You know, maybe just a manifestation of the Holy Spirit that she talked to.
You know, Langley, I've read that in your culture, numbers are very powerful, and lucky numbers are quite powerful.
Oh, yes.
And
yes.
I read a fascinating article the other day. It talked about how many people who come from China to the United States change their names because it fits in a little better. Many people named Angel, Grace, but one guy, he knows the number one is the luckiest number, but two ones are even more lucky. So he changed his name to 11. And then he started working in an office, and then they scheduled a meeting, and it was bad because they wanted to have the meeting at 10 with 11. And he had to change his name again. And I'm dead serious. It was in this article. It was very interesting.
I vaguely remember that.
That's weird.
That's scary.
I'm trying to come up with the trivia.
That's good.
All right, so you guys are all agreed to go to Joe and Trout. You went for a trip to see Abuela?
Sounds good.
She'll make some homemade tortillas for you guys. Yeah.
All right.
When did your family become Mexican?
Yeah, are you Mexican or Native American?
You don't, I guess they're kind of a little bit.
Or is it like
we're a little bit of everything.
Okay, gotcha.
She is Comanche.
He's like Tiger Woods.
Okay.
A little of this, a little of that.
Yeah. Half black, half Asian. Oh, no, his wife is Asian.
Yeah, I don't know.
His wife is Swedish, right? Or was Swedish? His ex-wife?
Oh, no, it is. No, Tiger is not Asian. I'm thinking back to the racial draft from Chappelle's show.
All right, so you guys head on home. Do you? Oh, you drive past Mom's on the way. Do you get some chili to go?
Oh yeah, I want some of that Atomic chili. Atomic chili, very good.
Okay. Mom says she got the hot, it's a special one for you. So
that. Oh, that's
right. It's Fireball Thursday. Anybody else want the super atomic chili?
I'll just take the atomic. That's good enough for me.
No. Edison curls out into a single ball.
I got your glass of milk, son.
Just to be able to walk into the joint.
He looks at the milk, distrustingly. Does it look okay?
It's fine.
He drinks it.
You guys want some atomic chili for the road?
Sounds good to me.
Or super atomic chili for Trout.
How far are we going on the, like, oh, this is just go back to the dorm?
This is back to the dorm.
Oh, okay. You guys are safe then.
All right, you guys do your evening thing. Maybe study. Look at some porn, smoke some weed, whatever. Go to sleep. Have very your series of... What do you call it?
No.
For what?
Crystal sick.
Who's
sick? Crystal is sick.
Crystal.
The babysitter?
Oh, yeah, it might be the babysitter. The lady gets what? Them on the bus.
Oh, okay, so don't like care, just the effect.
Yes. Well, I guess
no one cares a person. About her as a person. So maybe.
Yes.
Is Sherry? I thought...
Let's try to make Sherry not?
No, it's for the bus in the morning. School bus for the kids. So
they get a
quick. So they just call my mom and my father. Come help, please. You spend your night, you have your bad dreams.
Again.
Yes. All of you.
See that walk coming alive.
Yes. And then we'll wait for Jeff for the ride up. Mike and Joel, if you want to take a second and actually, Adam, if you want to pull up Google Maps and Google Briscoe, Texas.
Like Briscoe County Jr.?
Like Briscoe County Jr. Jeff sent me the link.
Okay.
It is a sticks town. Out in a stick town in Texas.
I have yet to watch more than the pilot for that show.
Oh come on.
I haven't seen the whole show. I haven't seen the whole episode. All
you gotta stick through towards the end. Because it gets
wonky.
Crazy and entertaining and clever and science fiction. And I won't say anymore.
I've got so much to go through. I still have to watch the season finale of S.H.I.E.L.D. I finally watched the penultimate one this weekend.
The Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. The S.H.I.E.L.D.
with the Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.
There's about six streets in this town.
Briscoe County.
No, just Briscoe, Texas.
Here. Oh, Briscoe, Texas. Okay.
Oh, it's in the panhandle.
Oh, yep. It is in North Texas.
Good night, Amy.
Good night.
We'll see
you in a couple of weeks.
Yes.
Kevin wanted to do TI next week, so.
Oh, okay.
We'll see.
Maybe we'll see you next week.
Maybe next week is.
That's why I haven't responded to him yet. I have to talk to you about it.
Yeah, next week is crazy insane.
There is about six streets in that town.
Holy moly, Joel's right. It is literally six streets, isn't it?
So I'm guessing that he went to.
This is where his grandmother is.
School?
This is where his grandmother is, not necessarily where he grew up.
Oh, gotcha. And there's a state forest.
Checking on George in there?
Hey, do Google Maps of the closest hospital from Briscoe. How many miles away is the local hospital?
Just because I don't know how to do generic search.
Joel, Mikey, did you pull it up?
If you go
I got
to the search window and then type directions.
Can't get street view.
Do you see how that dropped out here? Click there and click on directions.
Film in our bed.
Hospital. Yeah. Just curious.
If you click on the satellite aerial view,
yeah.
It's pretty hysterical.
What does it look like, Mike?
There are, like Joel said, there's about six streets, but most of the streets don't contain any buildings.
Oh, gosh.
How did you find Briscoe, Texas?
This is. I looked up northern Texas.
We could not find a hospital.
I found Briscoe. I saw Briscoe. I thought that was perfect.
Well, hospital near
maybe Briscoe County?
Yeah, it's about said.
There's about 10 trees in the city.
All right, let's go to satellite
the
view.
Town or...
Let's take a look at the satellite view.
That
that's
where
crazy.
The bachelor lives look like a big city.
Yes.
I'm not from. I'm from a couple towns over, but that's where she lives.
Is your hometown
like,
town
like
bigger?
Area?
A little bit bigger.
Oh, all right.
We have a stoplight.
Adam, do you want to go?
Trying to get back into a good Zoom level. Oh,
if you click on the Santa Fe Depot, it's actually a building that looks like it should be condemned and knocked down.
Is there a street map view as well? Oh, no. No, Google's not been through here.
Yeah, just look. Amy didn't need it.
Oh, we didn't tell?
No,
oh,
she didn't
want it.
Oh.
Oh, my goodness.
This is a cool
wow. It is a desolate place.
There's a purple building.
Look at this. Have you
the
ever
main,
seen a big
the main road, the main road that goes through it is called Cowboy Creek.
And there's just so much like empty dirt lots with nothing, not even grass.
You're right. She's on the reservation. That's as close city to the reservation.
Yeah. But you know what? The football field looks great.
Seriously. Everything else is like there's no grass, and the football field is this patch, rectangular patch of green. That's crazy.
I assume that's a football field.
Yeah.
Oh, definitely.
All right, who's driving what vehicle? Because this is a long ride. It's a couple hours.
Take two cars?
Yeah, we'd have to, I think, at this point, because...
Well, or you're uncomfortably in
medicine.
Oh, nice.
You notice that all these roads are dirt roads?
Well, there's a couple paved ones.
Just the one paved road that goes through town.
Yep.
Everything else is dirt.
There's a couple side ones that are...
Dean Street might be paved.
Yeah, it looks like some of these.
Yeah, Deacon Street is paved, and Wilson Avenue's paved. But that's because Wilson Avenue heads to the school.
I chose wisely.
It's either that or this is asphalt.
Deacon Street looks like a dirt road to me.
No, I got it on...
Okay.
I got it on aerial view. It's definitely paved.
Edison is happy to drive his car, but I warn you, it's she's temperamental sometimes. The engine sometimes doesn't sit right.
I can take my bike if somebody wants to ride on the back.
I'd rather drive my car.
It'd be a long, hot drive.
Ah, with the wind in your face. It's nice.
No, the wind would be in your face. The back of your head would be in my face. I don't think I like that.
All right, so some of you pile in Joe Diffie's Jeep, and the rest go with Edison?
Yeah. What's wrong with Joe Diffie's Jeep?
Doesn't hold five.
No, I mean, but it's got to have something else wrong with it, too.
No, he's rich.
Mm. Oh!
I bet it holds five.
I guess I have to roll. I think a 1d6, and if I get a 1, I think it's 1d6. The car doesn't start.
We could fit in with Joe Diffie's. Someone's on the home seat.
Five. Car starts, I'm good.
I go with Joe Diffie.
I'm waiting for Trout to call to get the limo.
All right,
he's got a pickup truck.
Get the plane.
Get the plane. Yeah. Helicopter.
That reminds me of Bull Durham. No, Brewster's Millions.
All right, you pile in the car.
I've got a great game for our road trip. It's called Murder. Mary. And I can't remember what the other one is, but we could play that game. I don't know how it works. Never mind.
All right, so you head out. Who are you riding with, Cochise?
I'll ride with
Edison.
Edison.
All right, so Cochise and Edison are in the lead because Cochise is the one who knows where you're going. Juan Lowe is it riding with Joe Diffie? Trout, where are you?
Nice new air conditioned car.
It is not the air conditioning. It's got the top off and the doors off and everything off.
Oh, we got a Jeep. That's
a tough guy.
That is this car's air conditioning. Just so you know.
Right now.
But it doesn't work.
No, it works. It works. It's just the engine doesn't start sometimes. That's all.
Joel, who are you riding with?
So I'm with the Chief.
Your choice. You can ride with Edison and Cochise, or you can ride with Juan Lowe and Joe Diffie.
All right. I'll ride with Juan Lowe and Joe Diffie.
Say shot.
I like riding with Joe Diffie.
All right.
Wait a minute. If Joe Diffie and Flounder and Trout are going to be together, I might not be comfortable in that car.
All right. You head on out on the highway.
So you got the motor running?
Got your motor running.
Johnny, how long has it been since you've seen your
little Thunder?
A couple months. We're very close.
All right.
Must be nice.
It's actually great-grandmother.
Oh, really?
Oh, so she's not an abuelita.
How old is she?
90-ish.
Wow, God bless her.
She doesn't really have an exact birthday.
So Joe Diffie and Edison, I need a driving role. I only care if it's a one.
I'm untrained in driving.
I only care if it's a one. If one of them is a one.
Okay. Edison is not a good driver.
No. Wait, one for me. I rolled a 3 on my dice and a 5 on the other on my other one.
7 minus 2 is a 5.
I don't care if you drive. All right. So you avoid the...
Minus 2 with the jack of all trades, right?
Oh, yeah. So it would have been a 7.
You avoid the armadillo crossing the street.
Phew. I could have been a Rango.
Could have been dinner. My grandmother would have loved that.
Another victim of the needler. You want to go back?
No.
You get about an hour away. You're getting on those stretches now where there's nothing.
Not even radio reception.
Next exit 30 miles kind of stuff.
Johnny, can you try the radio one more time? Maybe there's a new station now. What? Oh,
I brought some CDs.
No cell phone service. He's got experience.
Have you ever driven to Montreal through upstate New York up to Canada?
Mm-hmm.
There's a good big stretch over there. No, it's hills and trees and no radio.
Yeah, across Pennsylvania, similar. Yeah. So.
Although the religious radio stations come in like crystal clear.
Double ones. Edison's car overheats.
Ka-chunk, ka-chunk. I'm going to turn her over. I think we got a problem here.
Let's take a look.
So you guys behind notice Edison pulls over, steam pouring out of the engine.
Edison takes a look at it. He's got knowledge, mechanical engineering. He's also got the MacGyver edge.
All right.
Does any of that help?
Sure.
I have the repair skill.
Oh.
So maybe I could assist you with...
Maybe I assist you. How good is your repair skill?
D4.
D6. Mechanical engineering.
All right, so go ahead and...
You guys are going to stick your hands in an engine that just overheated.
We'll give it an hour. It's sweltering hot.
Man,
your Clark Griswold wandering in the desert.
With her pants on her head.
Oh, even a 4, you give me +2.
I got a 15. But it's your plus
it's
two.
It's not much hotter out here than it is inside of that radiator right now.
17. So Edison takes the pantyhose he finds on the side of the road, fixes his the belt of the car with it. That was MacGyver.
That's good, Edison. Then Edison shaves off the paint of a bicycle and turns it into a bomb. Just because he had the time.
The cracked radiator block he fixes.
No, he doesn't fix that.
You guys get back out on the road.
What if that either
an while you're fixing it, there's an while you're fixing it, Jeff, there's an armadillo. Yeah.
I don't have any shooting.
You got throwing ball, right?
I do have throwing.
How about a rock? How fast is an armadillo? Or a tire iron?
Tire iron. That's just taking the fun out of it.
Mm. Let me try to throw something at it. A rock.
There's plenty of rocks around.
Oh, I think he exploded.
Seven.
Ooh.
Seven. All right, give me a damage here.
We might have some armadillo soup.
Strength plus D4.
Just don't let it hurt me.
Reach a top speed of 30 miles per hour.
An armadillo can run 30 miles an hour. Wow, according to the Google page that Adam just brought up.
By Adam, for damage?
Yes.
Six.
Ooh. Cochise is schooling you guys in the old ways. Conks, tell me.
I conk it right in the forehead.
Whoa, what are you doing there?
And I hustle over there and finish off the job with the rock.
Jules Kager style.
Wait, Johnny, did you just kill an armadillo?
Yeah, we're going to have it for dinner.
But
you never had an armadillo?
Can't we just order Chinese or, you know, get some fried chicken or something?
Did you see the map?
Are you bringing it?
No, I didn't think to.
Is he getting the hat?
Grab it by the tail.
Is he getting the hat?
Armadillo hat. Plus one.
Armor.
All right, you cut your armadillo, I guess. So
but wrap that up.
No, that's, I'm not that good.
That's 100%.
I'm bringing the whole thing and put it in the trunk.
That's genuine plush on the back seat there. We don't want to. This is a 1986 Datsun, the finest machine of its kind. We don't want to get blown up.
Hey, Cochise, shouldn't you be gutting that thing? Isn't that thing going to stink in the back of that car?
No, we got like 8 hours before it starts to even remotely start to stink.
How long until we get there?
Mike's like, there
five.
You go.
Five if the car was working right now.
Oh, God.
Well, Mike, we're going to hand wave that so you can have armadillo soup later.
Okay, that's good. I prefer not to die of poisoning from my armadillo soup. Because you left all the organs inside of it while they were rotting away from not being fed with blood.
You got to get them right away.
All right, I'll get it right away. I'll be very careful not to.
I'm just saying. I mean, for an Indian to throw a rock and kill an armadillo, you think you'd know the
guts. Everybody in that coach chief make a vigor roll. I want to see who throws up. Because watching the gut.
Have you ever seen Street Meat Hong Kong?
Yeah, I've never seen the gut part.
Hey, what are you doing over? Oh God!
I've seen skinned cats still trying to meow.
Edison throws up on the side of the road. He's completely turned off. He can't even see the
shoes. Out of sneakers.
Yeah, out of sneakers. Yeah.
Yeah.
Joel, Mikey, vigor check. Got to see if you're throwing up from the.
Oh, seriously, a vigor check?
Yeah.
5.
You're a city slicker. You're okay though. Trout?
I gotta make one?
Yep, bigger check.
Again, Andrea says to me, what did you do tonight for game night? Oh, I rolled a bigger check to see if I threw up from gutting an armadillo. Like, yeah, I'll tell them about that. Sure.
We talk about cracking bones and sucking marrow, and the answer was, yeah, sure.
Oh, in a game night, could you say? Getting an armadillo.
Andrew says, did you learn anything interesting tonight? Yeah, armadillos can run at top speed of 330 miles an hour.
What'd you get, Joel?
Some species
Three.
Prefer to run rather
Three.
Than go walk.
Three.
Trout and Edison's stomachs are both very unhappy after watching the gutting of the armadillo.
Yeah, that would be good. I don't feel so good.
So.
Just be careful when you take her out at first. She's very temperamental.
You got it.
All right.
All right, Cochise is in the lead with the Edison's mobile.
Okay, it didn't stop. Okay.
And Cochise, tell us what you see when you give me the directions. What happens? How you get there?
So we'll pull it in.
Go north.
We find a small village that we drive through. I tell you guys it's about three times the size of where my grandma lives.
Is there other teepees?
It's just a couple more little towns that we have to pass through.
This is very tiny, Johnny. It's a very small place.
Yeah.
Wow.
We see a sign for Briscoe, Texas, population 235.
Oh, there's a sign for it?
And she actually doesn't live in the town, or she's outside of the town.
So we can't go to the football field?
We could.
Is it a reservation?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, it's not an official reservation, but there's a lot of natives in the area.
Okay.
I couldn't actually find a...
Hey, Coach, are we anywhere where the wounded knee thing happened?
No, not close to there.
I'd like to see how they fixed his knee, man.
We're the Comanches. We're tough guys on horses.
Comanches, your tribe were a tribe of warrior horse people. Is that right?
That's right.
Wow.
Until they took off the horses and killed them.
When this whole trip is over, can I get me an Indian name too?
Do you get you an Indian name too?
Like, Runs with Blondie.
All right. So you get to there.
We see a little adobe style house.
Oh, isn't that cute? Look, like Yoda must live there.
About 10 or 12 of them in the area?
Yeah, well, I go spread out over a few acres. It's really dry and desolate there. Little stone wall around there.
I like what they've done with the landscape. No, it really looks horrible. This is just horrible. Oh my
couple
God.
Of, a couple goats.
This is like some sort
around.
Of wasteland.
If you go back to roll 20, you can see what she looks like as she comes out of her little adobe shack.
I think I played this game on the computer once. Fall out.
I.
War. War changes. Oh, war never changes.
That looks familiar. That is a tribal woman with two white stripes on her forehead and a dot on the bridge of her nose. She looks very old. She's got tattoos on her wrinkled, almost parchment-like hand.
It looks like a mummy.
She kind of looks like a
mummy.
Sure,
that's a living person.
Yeah, it's my grandmother.
I bet
Josh. Great-grandmother.
I would insult you like
that. Oh, no. Jeff, I need two pictures. Your grandmother and your girlfriend.
Oh, okay.
I told him he could pick which one's which.
He chose wisely.
As soon as she's waiting for you, she comes out to greet you.
Well, I knew you guys would come.
It's about time you came to visit.
How you doing? I brought all my friends. I hope that's all right.
That's great. I told you to.
I brought some dinner with us.
What'd you get?
I go out and I give her the armadillo.
Oh, it's been a while since we have an armadillo.
Edison covers his mouth, looking pale.
Let me go. Make yourselves at home. I'll be right back. I'm going to get this going on a stew. We'll be back in a few minutes.
We go out back. There's a nice little chair set up.
Chairs.
Little fire.
Chairs, a table, and a concrete slab. That's called the porch.
That is no concrete slab.
So, John, do you get internet here?
She doesn't have a phone.
Half of the houses get electricity here.
Oh, my God, that's horrible.
You're on the side of the town that doesn't.
Oh, my God, this is horrible.
Running water?
That's a good Indian name. That's what you could have for your Indian name. Running water.
It depends on how much it's rained lately. Yeah.
And I think I know what my Indian name will be. Faster bit rate. Yes.
All right, so she comes out about 20 minutes later.
I got a name for you, Edison.
Yeah.
Can't shut the fuck up.
Oh, no. No, my Indian name is Babbling Brook.
No. No, your Indian name is Babbling Ass.
Oh, that wasn't very nice.
After the talk with Shirley a few weeks ago, that was very appropriate.
Way to go, Wanglo. Good one.
I'd rather not talk about it. That was a very traumatizing time in my life.
Yeah, I should have asked you yesterday. Did you want something?
No. Wait till we come up with your Indian name.
What was her Indian name?
Wakanda.
What? From X-Men? Avengers?
Wakanda is where Black Panther's from.
Yeah.
Ah.
Jeff faked that name. I gave him a link for
Just right as
so
Indian.
She's African too?
No.
Nope.
She's a spirit guide, dude.
Wakanda means
she's a shaman.
Oh, it means what is it? Touched by magic or something.
Spiritual one or something like
yeah.
that. Or...
Johnny Moon, do you have an Indian name?
Yeah,
I do. It's roughly means Johnny Moon. Yeah, it's not.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, all right.
So she goes back out and she sits down just and try to picture an old Indian woman talking because I'm not going to even try the accent. A broken English. Just.
Give it a shot.
She comes over. She gives Johnny a hug and a kiss on the cheek. And you can tell that whatever she says, he will immediately do. Mm. Utmost respect, fear, respect, all of it rolled one.
Well, she seems sure like a nice woman, doesn't she?
I can't understand what she's saying.
Me neither. That's why she seems like a nice woman.
And she comes over and she doesn't say anything. She looks, she gets right at everybody's face. She's studying Juan Lo. She moves over to Edison.
Edison has trouble making eye contact. He looks down. He rubs the bridge of his nose nervously.
She actually grabs your head and with your thumb opens your eyelids so you have to look right at her.
Uh-huh.
totally crosses every personal boundary you have.
Johnny, save me! Johnny!
This is the closest he's gotten to a woman all semester.
This is the closest Edison has been to a woman. That's
since his birth.
Probably since birth.
She walks over to Joe Diffie, looks him over, touches his hair like, how the hell is that standing up?
That's not the only... Oh,
okay. Walks over to Trout. She's the first person all day that doesn't completely diss Trout.
Higher.
Your halitosis is gone. Your curse this week is all NPCs dislike you.
Oh...
But Wakanda does not seem to be affected by that.
Ooh, she can see beyond.
And she actually looks at, as she's looking at you, and she's like, she says something about a bit of dark stuck inside. So she comes back and she sits down.
To whom does she say that? To Trout?
Yeah.
Ooh. Has he been taking iron pills?
So why are you here, Johnny?
You know, we needed a break from college for a couple of days. We figured we'd come up here.
There's no fresher air to be had.
Edison is playing with his smartphone trying to get a signal, and he looks more and more panicked as he realizes...
And the battery's just going...
she walks over, takes it out of your hand.
Sorry.
Puts it face down on the little table next to you.
Oh,
You don't need that here.
But it's got... It's
you
got,
don't need that here.
I can call 911.
You, no, you can't.
Yes, ma'am.
You don't need that here.
Yes, ma'am.
There is no 911 here at Edison.
And you find yourself wanting to do immediately what she says. You don't need that here. Okay.
This is not the cell phone here. You're looking for.
Yes. She has charisma. She has charisma plus 12.
This is not the signal you're looking for.
So what? You don't visit just for fun, Johnny. I know.
We've had some weird run-ins in college.
I see.
We've seen some things that we can't really explain.
Tell me what you have seen.
Maybe you could use your. What you've seen and know about to help us explain this.
I ask her, what is the proper way to address you, ma'am?
You may call me Wakanda.
Wakanda, my name is Joe. I've been friends with Johnny since we got to college. To be honest with you, Wakanda, there has been some very, very weird stuff that I have never experienced in my life.
We go back to the first day.
She pulls Joe Diffie close, smells his hair. And she goes, I know why you see things.
I know what?
I know why you see things.
You know why I see things?
Yes.
Wakanda, we have seen shit that'll turn you white.
I show her my arm.
I don't want to be a white man.
I show her my arm where it got burned by the...
Oh, what are you doing there, kitty?
He's trying to unbury one of the bowls.
He doesn't know he's a
key. Yeah,
so
right.
She takes your arm and she touches it and she rubs her hand over it. And it feels better. You know, it actually fades a little bit as she rubs her hand over it. Edison is floored because it's, you know, defies logic.
That is incredible. How in the world if I could just record this or put some sort of heat monitor or geosignature, that's, how does that feel?
He always talks like this.
It's okay. He could try to record, but it will not work.
I feel completely compelled to tell this woman about the horrible dreams that I've been having and the lack of sleep due to it from the experience at the first night.
The roost.
The roost.
And she listens very intently, asks a few probing questions.
We've all had trouble sleeping.
And she turns to Trout. No, Trout was with... Trout and Joe left together, right? So she turns to Edison, who's decidedly the least comfortable one of the lot.
Definitely.
Tell me what happened when they left.
Well, ma'am, your majesty, it was kind of like this.
And she puts her hand on your leg.
Whoa.
In a comforting way. And you're suddenly very relaxed.
Edison feels calm.
Yeah.
So now he's speaking as if he's talking to one of his guild members on Warcraft.
She's really good.
Well, it went down like this. We heard a sound, and Johnny and I both ran to check it out. I think I ran, and then Johnny followed me.
Are we talking
this
about...
Is, is that the roost?
Oh, the roost.
First time. Yeah.
Remember we were going to a stage?
He's dipping his paw in the water. And then licking the paw.
That's kind of adorable.
You're doing it wrong.
I know. There are some cats like moving water.
Yeah.
And a friend of mine, a cat, would swirl the water around before she would drink it.
So yeah. Anyway, sorry to interrupt. Let's go ahead. Tell me what you've seen. If you just want to say.
Yeah, he describes the fact that all the doors were locked, and then out of the wall, something that was sort of invisible but blurry appeared, grabbing the security guard and pulling him away to an unknown fate. And the heat that emerged, and the woman that appeared and touched.
And unfortunately, this seems to be almost the norm.
Yes, the area of Pinebox has been... I will use the term cursed, but is that the correct term?
Wait, cursed? Cursed? Joe's like, cursed? What do you mean cursed?
The activity happens there, often. The spirits are unhappy there.
Whose spirits?
The spirits of nature.
You mean like the trees and the birds?
Yes, all of them.
And the squirrels?
The earth
itself. Do we need to bless those spirits and all get beschmuffed?
Well, that's not good.
We have to have the sacramental wine first.
There's a lot of people who live there. A lot of people who could be endangered by these angry spirits.
They choose where they live.
Well, then maybe the people of Pinebox should choose to live someplace else.
Maybe they choose to live there because they're trying to help the spirits. Or the spirits are looking for their help.
Well, I find this very different from my understanding of the universe, I have to say. Wow.
We go on to talk about our run-ins with Dr. Jackson, Mr. Jackson.
Glenn Mack and Mr. Jackson.
Professor Mack and Mr. Jackson.
Yeah. But they're a little more... technology side of the spirit world trying to capture it.
Yes, I do not understand this technology. She picks up your phone and you can see out of the corner of your eye, it just goes.
No, see, what you gotta do is you gotta get all the candies in a row and then.
No, it's like, it's like the screen kinda.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, God. Oh, God.
Is that bad?
Oh, no, ma'am. No.
I'm sorry.
It's okay.
How did the blue screen of death show up on an iPhone?
No.
What you want, kidding?
So the conversation continues for a while, and then she says, well, let us eat first, and then we'll carry on. Johnny, will you light the fire while I get the food?
Yes.
Johnny, what are we having for dinner? It's not...
Probably going to have some soup and a little bit of barbecue.
Oh, all right.
Actually,
good.
It's not technically barbecue. It's not a good one.
So it ain't the armadillo. We're
not as far as you know.
All right. Okay.
Tastes like chicken.
Tastes like chicken.
She brings out a bowl of soup for everybody. And she turns to Edison as she puts his down and she goes, "Don't worry, I replaced yours with chicken."
Thank you, madam.
That looks and tastes exactly like ours.
Appreciate that, Your Majesty.
So you dig into your dinners.
Edison loves it. He finds it delicious. He finishes the bowl. Then you see him lifting the bowl to get the last drops.
Would you like more?
Well, I'd love more, but I think I'm full.
Yeah, armadillo is very filling.
Well, good thing I wasn't eating armadillo then. I mean, it's good that it was just chicken, right? What? No, you're shaking your head. No. Did I just eat armadillo?
Quite good, isn't it?
Yeah.
I have the shell drying if you'd like the hat.
No, thank you. That's a very nice gesture. No, thank you. I think I've had enough armadillo. I can't metagame. He's not going to wear an armadillo hat. You can take the armadillo.
You can take the hat back to your room and never wear it again. I don't care. All right. I just throw it out there for funny games.
All right. Well, that's a very nice gesture. I see Johnny's kicking me under the table. Thank you. Thank you, Your Majesty Wakanda.
She looks over at Trout. How did Trout like the armadillo, Joel? Joel?
What?
How did Trout like the armadillo?
It kind of turns his stomach a little bit.
Really? She offers more. That's what she does. All right.
A little more hot sauce on it. It'd go in the chili, I guess.
All right, we're done. Just like being home. Delicious. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
All right.
Now, I never thought an armadillo could taste this good.
Well, we think it's the same spirit. On a night when we are explaining the scavenger hunt, and we get free pizza for the whole semester.
One day you'll have to bring me one of these pizza things.
That's it. Pizza's where you take the dough, you take the dough and flatten it out, and you put ground up tomatoes and herbs together.
She knows what it is. She's never had one. Too much beer?
Yeah. But at least that means I'm sobering up.
Yes. All right. Well, I would like to perform a ritual to see what if I can see what my son has seen, my great grandson has seen, and I will share that vision with you.
Well, we didn't have a camera phone out. He didn't capture any video. Like, what were you thinking? Like downloading from his jump drive on his phone, but the camera wasn't on.
You speak these words. The spirits will show us.
Huh. All right.
And I thought maybe you could help us with the sleeping. I know you've helped people out in the past.
Just let us try this first thing, and then we'll address that.
If it God will, then we'll read your question.
So she sits everybody down around the fire, and typical medicine woman thing. She's got her little smoky thing. She's flailing around a little bit. And
is there chanting?
There's chanting.
It's like a candela.
Slower. It's a much more subdued chanting. Yes.
Edison is fascinated.
And she sits down, and she goes, "Before you continue, you must all choose a spirit name." She turns to Johnny. Johnny's already chosen his. He knows his.
Johnny, what's your spirit name?
Son of Moon.
I was going to think of like Night Bringer or something like
that. Pick something. You all got to choose one. You all have 1 minute to figure out your spirit name.
All right, so Wakanda, I want my spirit name. I've put a great deal of thought into this. And I want to be called Thor. No, wait, Loki. No, wait, can you call me the Hulk? Can you?
Your spirit name is He Who Does Not Shut Up.
Babbling Brook. That's what I was thinking.
Babbling Brook will work fine. Well, you are the Babbling Brook.
All right, thank you. But I have other ideas if you want to hear them. I'm more than happy to list them out.
Mike or Joel, do you have one?
I was going to go with Runs with Biscotti, but...
She looks at Joe Diffie, and she goes, "He who explores other views."
Oh, for fuck's sake, really?
He who explores other views?
He doesn't like that
No.
So,
I'm trying to look up.
Like, when you look through a window, you see other views, so you're saying his spirit name is Windows Explorer?
I go,
next time I get a hold of his water bottle, I'm doubling the dose.
Your spirit name is Smoky Vision.
Oh.
Smoky Vision sounds fitting.
She does seem to know you pretty well. Trout, do you have a name picked out?
How about Sunset Over the Plateau?
That will work. I was going to go with something dimmer. His trout is a little dim, but we'll let Joel pick his. Jeff, have you, or Adam? Stop Googling and just have fun with it.
No, I'm trying to look up the name because I think that...
He's looking up novelty Chinese food names right now.
No. I'm trying to look
dim
up
the name
of the gang that I was in.
Mia Koda, which means power of the moon.
Oh. Poder de la luna.
Mia Koda.
I thought I gave this name. Street urchin. Singing scorpion. Warner Brothers, the frog.
Hello, my baby. Hello, my darling. Hello, my darling.
The mascot for the channel.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. So the...
Did you ever see the cartoon?
The...
No. YouTube. 2 minutes long. Very funny.
The ritual proceeds, and the smoke starts to... She's throwing other things onto the fire. She passes around a bowl. You all drink from it. You're all getting pretty loopy.
What's in here? Because I'm sometimes lactose intolerant, and I prefer a gluten-free...
Babbling Brook.
Hmm? Oh, right. Okay.
Enjoy.
Alright.
And you all slowly started to settle in. And you have no idea how much time has passed. The moon, you're vaguely aware of the moon traveling over the sky as night.
So it's just another day for me.
Passes. And you see in the smoke comes to fruition. Just for a second.
Oh! Oh my gosh. That is creepy.
And then it's gone.
Does somebody want to try to describe that for the audio viewers?
Mikey and Joel, did you see that?
No, I couldn't see it.
Are you not in roll 20? Joel?
Hmm?
Are you not in roll 20?
No, I'm not.
Ah, that would be why.
I am, but I must have to just scroll around a little bit.
I'm in my roll 20 if you want to show it again.
All I see is the East Texas University logo.
Right, but did you see the creature I flashed for a second?
No.
All right.
I must not. I must have been up in the logo, so I didn't see it.
Okay, I'm going to put it back on for a second. I only want you to see it for a second.
Okay, that's her. I see her. Okay.
You both see it?
Got it.
Joel?
I'm trying to open up roll 20.
So imagine, if you will... many werewolf movies where the werewolf is in the process of transforming, but he's not a werewolf. He's like halfway there or something.
I definitely thought wolfish. It also looks like perhaps a very hairy orc.
Yeah.
From Lord of the Rings.
Or maybe like if you were bit by a were-porcupine. I think if you were transforming into a were-porcupine, you would look like that with a very feral snarl and like hatred in eyes, big black pupils. I think it had like very long canine type fangs, but it definitely looked more humanoid.
It definitely didn't have a muzzle or a snout at all, just a pushed in nose.
Yeah, and the spikes were like coming out of its face, but all in one direction. Like you could, if you put your hand from your chin to your forehead and you went bottom to top, you would not cut yourself. But if you go the other way, you're going to get a face full of pines. That's how I would describe it.
Mm-hmm.
You got it going, Joel?
No, I'm getting an error message. I mean, don't worry about it.
Okay. You guys got your glimpse. That was all you were supposed to get, so.
What the hell was that? Your Majesty Wakanda?
That is what Johnny saw in the alley.
Oh, my goodness.
Now it is time to rest. Tomorrow, you will approach your other problems.
All right.
And you just sleep under the stars.
You just pass out in the circle.
She gives you each a blanket and a little pillow, and you just sleep under the stars. It's the best night's sleep you've had since as long as you can remember.
It's been dry lately, so there's no bugs.
No snakes.
Fantastic.
No armadillos.
Snake. Snake would have made the stew even better than armadillo.
But you guys, best sleep you've had in like years. You wake up feeling like $1 million.
You should do paleo more often.
Is this what they call the paleo diet? Is that what we're doing right now? It's wonderful, I have to say.
Edison gets up extra early to finish off his differential calculus homework.
You brought it with you?
Yeah, of course.
Good old Diffy Q's.
God, that was miserable.
Huh?
You an engineering major?
He's a mechanical engineering.
Oh.
He's me. Yeah, computer science.
I had a roommate who was an engineering major.
Oh.
And she's up even before you. She's up before the sun.
Whew.
You wake up and she's already, it looks like she's bent over Jeff at that point. Bent over him like.
No comments.
That's totally.
I thought I was up early helping her with the.
All right. She's bent over Joe Diffy. Looks like she's just touching his head a little bit or something, like she's looking for something.
Edison watches, but he doesn't see anything.
Alright.
What is up with Joe Diffie's hair? Is it just spiked? Or
it's just spiked. If you look at the Ferris Bueller's picture he had, the hair spiked like,
okay.
Like 2.5 inches tall, spiked up. So, you know, this is rural Texas.
Picture Joe Dirt.
One of them wears it well, the other not so much. Yeah.
Alright, I need a pee break myself, so hold on.
You know, Joe Dirt is, they're going to put out a sequel. I think it's going on Yahoo, straight to Yahoo, in some video. I guess I'd have to watch the first one.
It couldn't even make it to Netflix, it's going to be that good.
Yeah.
It didn't go straight to home video. It didn't go to Netflix, it went to Yahoo.
Yeah.
Nobody, I didn't even know Yahoo had a video service.
They do. They have original programming, one of which won a couple of Academy Awards, I think.
Really?
The Oscars, yeah. They have one called, and I haven't seen it, but Transparent, I think it's called. And it is about a father who decides that he should dress up as a woman, and his family has to accommodate for his changing lifestyle.
So that's from Arrested Development, right?
Yes. Yeah, I think that's it.
Oh, wait, you're talking about, which there's the patriarch?
The bald guy with
Bob. Oh, Jeffrey Tambor.
Yeah.
Jeffrey Tambor.
Oh, my goodness. Okay, that just puts a whole new spin on the show.
But I think it's like serious drama. I don't think there's a lot of
movie. It's funny, but it's serious.
Have you seen it?
No.
Oh, okay.
I've seen him interviewed, though.
Supposedly, it got really good reviews.
The Flash? Have you seen that?
I've heard The Flash is supposed to be pretty decent, but
my
I haven't
TiVo is piling up The Flash in, what's the one that preceded it? The Green Arrow? Green Arrow. And I intend to one day kind of burn through those.
I think the guy who was playing Arrow said he's not going to do Arrow anymore.
I think they're wrapping that up, but anyway.
But they're doing another series that's going to take like The Flash and The Arrow, and they're going to team up with other people, and that'll be another series.
Right, and Supergirl.
And Supergirl. Oh,
so is this Marvel Studios?
No, DC.
Then it doesn't matter.
All right, so you eventually all wake up. You feel, like I said, it's the best you've felt in a long time. Completely relaxed.
On the hard-packed earth.
It's amazing.
It is what it is, yeah.
So it's the fresh air. So she provides you with breakfast, traditional?
Some armadillo. A little bit of chopped armadillo, a little bit of some corn, something.
She directs you to the outhouse as needed. Edison, she directs you to the outhouse as needed.
Oh, it's armadillo again? This is chicken, right? This is not armadillo. We ran out of armadillo. It's chicken for breakfast. This is like a chicken burrito.
Tastes like chicken.
I'm starting to feel like I'm George Bush, right? Make no mistake. Okay, all right.
You believe what you wish to believe. Here's your new hat.
Oh, thank you very, very much. This is a unexpected pleasure, I guess.
Turn it up
in there. Yeah, I don't know. His head fits perfectly well into the wall or something. I'm gonna let him out when you guys leave in an hour or so. Let him have his day. So, she says. So this morning I examined you all while you slept.
That's creepy.
You have all been touched by a spirit.
I don't like to talk about that. I saw a psychologist for it, but it's just really not.
Missy Jordan's mind.
I cannot help with what has happened to you. Your nightmares I could help with tonight, but I will not help when you leave here, they will return. Mm. You guys have to be back on. I assume you have to be back tomorrow.
Yeah, we got class.
So I know another man who may be able to help us. If you would like to go see him.
Well, I can't keep my grades up if I'm having nightmares every night. Yes, please.
Okay, let's go.
Who are we going to see?
I do not believe you know him.
Right. Is it possible that he lives in Houston, near like a TGI Fridays and a Starbucks, perhaps?
Houston is a long way away.
Your name is truly well suited to you.
Well, I just thought I'd ask.
Come. And she's just walking out into the desert.
Wait, don't we need a car, water, food?
The spirits will provide.
I don't have any sun protection. I need some SPF. My skin is very fair. I burn very easily.
Put your helmet on and let's go.
Does it smell?
He fits the helmet on.
It fits perfect.
And now your head is protected.
He looks like a bishop from a chessboard. Just a little round bit.
The tail's still on it, too.
Actually, if you ever saw Epcot Center grow legs and walk, like little skinny chicken legs, that would be him right now.
I see what Mike means about the Santa Fe Depot now. Take a look at this thing.
Holy moly, Mike. We're looking at the Santa Fe Depot in Briscoe County, the picture.
It looks like it left with the miners.
Wow.
Yowzes.
I just wanted to see, like, where is it in relation to, like, the rest of the world.
So, it's still early morning. The sun hasn't risen too much, so it's not a horrible walk.
Yet.
It does seem to drag on for quite some time. It's at least an hour and a half later.
There's one kind of major town to the left.
Yeah. By major, do you mean, like, something I've ever heard of?
You would have heard of it.
You guys know that, you can do without air for 3 minutes, you can do without water for 3 days, and you can do without food for 3 weeks.
I could go 4.
What?
I could go 4 weeks left.
It's the rule of threes in survival.
So eventually you stumble out, and all you see, it's a teepee. There's a single man sitting out in front of it, in front of the fire. And nobody seems to
care. Oh, there's a parking hospital, Bob.
Oh,
at this scale, that's probably like...
Are you kidding me?
I don't know.
Oh, it was 13 miles.
Is it the hospital?
Anyway, you
found the hospital. Well done.
These are county lines here.
Oh, Amarillo.
Oh, I'm pretty Amarillo.
All right, so you. You. Hello.
I'm listening. We're listening at the same time.
So you make it out to see this man. He makes her look young. His skin is leather.
Sir, would you like some SPF protection? It will take 37 years off the coat. Okay.
And she says, wait here. I will speak with him. And she goes, she has a canteen. You don't know where it came from.
It came out of Hammer Space.
So, you're having your little sip of water there.
Are they speaking in Comanche, so we have no idea what we're here?
And far off.
Okay.
Do you speak Comanche?
I know a little bit. For the most.
You understand, but don't
I
speak.
Understand. They can't speak it that well.
Well, this is a nice place. You seem like you have some nice family here, Johnny Moon.
Thank you.
Yeah. You think we'll get out of this alive?
And we'll be better for it.
All right. Okay.
Rattlesnake for lunch.
Every time I feel rattled, I come here and get centered.
Wow. I just like to, you know, play some video games. Helps me out. Go catch a movie. Avengers, maybe.
All right, so he comes back over with Wakanda.
So where's Pinebox, then?
Pinebox is north of Houston. It's like here.
That'll take 16 hours.
It's fucking far.
Easily.
Yeah. Actually, this may be that wooded area.
Where the bird is.
That little black dot there, that's the bird. See it right there?
50 miles is about...
What is this? Let me just do that.
All right. So, Adam is gone. He's run off to play with the map. Jeff is only sort of helping him. So he sits you down again and he says, You know, I need to commune with each of you. So you sit around the fire, sing Kumbaya.
Hey, Johnny Wood, this isn't like an Amway session, is it? They're not going to have us, like, buy things to sell to people after this, right?
No.
It's not like Scientology, right? I'm not signing a contract for a billion years, am I? All right.
All right, so you, he does his chanting and thing around each of you. He sits you around. He walks around. He walks around the outside of the circle. Sometimes he places his hand on your head or on your shoulders. And this goes on for like an hour. It's getting pretty uncomfortable sitting there that long. And he finally breaks and he says, "I will need some time to think of this. Think on this. You can help me now, though." And he gives you a whole bunch of mundane things to do. Go get me some water. Go dig this. Go do that. And he gives you the tools.
It's like hanging out with your father when you're a teenager.
Oh yeah, he totally gives you a list of things to do to keep you busy.
Mr. Miyagi.
Yes. Yes, exactly.
So that was taking the better part of the day. Edison's hands are burned and blistered. Everybody's tired and sore.
I just feel like this is like Tuesday for me during the summers.
This is the most horrible thing I've ever experienced. Oh my god.
So it's
finally I have some help with these chores instead of just me and my own.
The strongest light I've been exposed to in the past 10 years has been the radiation of a monitor of a flat screen in my face. This is too much.
Wakanda comes back, I guess, around 4 o'clock. She's carrying 5 rattlesnakes dead. Puts them on a spit over the fire.
That's, Your Majesty. That's, I'm sorry, but you got like a chicken somewhere?
It tastes like chicken.
Yeah, but I know.
Do you have any fish out here?
Some shrimp?
Maybe something else. You got like, have you got like a Hot Pocket, baby?
So, you finish up, he provides you with water to wash up a little bit, and dinner comes. It's the steak. Johnny Moon chops it down. Delicacy.
It's nothing new for Wan Lo either.
So he's all good with it.
Yeah, steak's no problem. He eats steak back in Hong Kong.
Trout, Joe Diffie.
Yep.
Rattlesnake.
Yeah, that's what we're doing.
Why not?
All right, so he serves up some rattlesnake. And isn't he going to eat, or you're starving? I mean, you're working all day.
I know, but it's rattlesnake.
Edison takes his fork, and he, like, pushes the rattlesnake to the right, but it doesn't look like there's less food. Then he pushes it to the back. It still doesn't look like there's no food. And then he comes to a decision, and he tries to hide the rattlesnake, like, in a circle around the rim of the plate to make it seem like he's eaten.
And how old are you?
Well, he doesn't want to offend. He thinks he can pull it off, but he has no guile. None whatsoever. And it, like, the pieces are sticking out. It's very obvious. That was great. Thank you.
You didn't taste it.
Well, it's so close. I think I know what it tastes like.
I think you need to try this. The spirits would not want this to go to waste.
Oh, it's not going to waste. Don't worry about that.
Do you guys think we just made Google Maps happy by clicking on that building? Do you think that's ever big? How much traffic has Briscoe, Texas gotten on Google Maps?
See, you think it was somebody had to go and take a picture of that building?
Do you think we just made somebody's day?
Probably. I think you're probably right. They have metrics for all that stuff, too. They want to look at it. Number of times clicked. Yeah, where people clicked from. Now they've got a click from Florida. They've got a click from Connecticut. That's pretty crazy. Yeah, he takes a bite. And his eyes widen in delight.
There you go.
It's delicious. He scarfs the rest of it down.
Excellent. Now, we will address the spirit that has touched each of you. Please come sit.
We sit.
You sit around the fire. Once again, magic stuff goes in the fire.
We drink the magic liquid of peyote.
Magic bowl goes around. Different this time. Tastes different. This is new even to Johnny Moon.
We're not finding our way back home.
This is different than Johnny Moon. You've never even had this one. So you start to see things. call them hallucinations, whatever.
I mixed some mushrooms in the paleo.
Whatever you want to call it. And you're reliving your night of the roost vividly. It's like you're doing it all over again. But you're trapped in your bodies, you can't change anything. Mm. And you're seeing the creature or you're seeing the fire. You can see things in slow motion a little bit.
Are we able to see them more clearly and understand more detail?
A little bit.
Does it help us in any way, shape, or form?
We'll get there.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Jeff recognized Johnny Boone, and everybody else is able to see the girl in great clarity now. The spirit that touched him.
The fire girl?
Yes.
Can we all see them? Or are we all really seeing what we saw?
You see through your own eyes, but you did all see her talking to him. So you're all able to see that.
Is that Mr. Jordan?
When she ignites, you feel the fire again. You swear your eyebrows are singed off. And then you're in the empty roost, and it's new. It's a new building, recently constructed. And you're running through the dark hallways. What are we pointing at?
Nothing, and nothing entirely game related. So I'm gonna shut up and just until you're done, I can wait for it.
Thank you. And you're running from somebody. You're all running as one person. It's like you're in somebody else's body, all five of you, seeing what that person is seeing. And you get the impression it's the girl that touched Cochise. And somebody's chasing her. And she's running. And you're hiding them. You can't escape them. She's running and she has something. And she's trying to find a place to hide it. And she closes it in some sort of container and stuffs it in a trophy case. And then it's caught on the middle of the floor and bursts in the flames, and you all wake up.
Ooh. Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Did you? Oh! It was running, and it was there, and then it caught on fire. It just blew up, and we put it in the trophy case, and we were running.
You saw the trophy case?
Yeah.
At the roost?
Yeah.
Can we all blow up?
Yeah.
Yeah, it got a bit of fire. Boom.
It was painful. It was really bad.
Joe and Trout, did you see the trophy case and get caught on fire?
What?
Joe and Trout, did you guys hear that the description of the dream I just gave you?
Yes.
Did you see the trophy case and catch fire?
No.
Yeah, you did.
oh, that trophy case. Yeah, I saw it.
Yes. It was a trophy case in the roost. And yes. You remember seeing it because of the replay of your dream. You remember seeing some of the trophy cases down by that room you went into where the guy told you to be a zebra.
Gotcha. I think I need to go back to that trophy case, guys.
I think you're right.
How do we get back to the car? We're in the middle of the desert.
What does it mean? Maybe we can learn more before we go.
Something happened to that girl that told Cochise a little bit about it.
Who was that girl?
I don't know. What time? Could we place a period by her clothing and hair?
You never see her.
Oh, okay.
You see through her eyes. Somebody's chasing her through the darkness. You can't see who it is.
So it was definitely a new building, not the old building before?
It was the roost, but much earlier in its lifetime. Because you recall the roost was fairly dilapidated when you were there.
It's the auditorium, right? So are there victory banners on the walls with the years of championships? Do you remember noting the years of football championships played?
You remember from your original vision, when they replayed what happened to you, that there were a lot of banners, not necessarily the details of them. Okay. But there were very few when you were chased through. It was dark, so it would have been hard to see them anyway. But
okay.
There was
just trying to figure out if we could use the banners to put a time to the when this happened. Okay.
Perhaps with some research and investigation.
Sure.
We were only there once.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Before about.
But we did just experience it in a dream state. That counts for something, I think. Oh god.
How is Joe Diffie taking all this? Because he is the doubter.
Joe Diffie is completely like beside himself. He knows he's seeing what he's seeing. He's having a hard time still believing it, but at this point he is just kind of in awe of the spirits and this whole experience. I mean, this experience, if anything, might be swaying him into believing.
I see. And what's Trout's take on it?
I guess I would agree.
Wanlo?
Hey, man, I saw what I saw. If we go and we check the trophy case, I think something will be there.
Even I'm surprised how vivid it was.
Yeah, that was new even for Johnny Williams.
Intense.
You
know, must be God wanted us to see it, so we see it.
What's this guy's name that we're with?
He's so old, no one knows his name. He's forgotten his name. Ooh, I'm surprised.
But he still remembers how to make the good drink.
I'm waiting for Bob to come back before we wrap up.
That's what I saw you putting your chips away.
I don't think I rolled dice tonight. I didn't even need to.
you rolled dice tonight to make a
car.
Einstein's car over
here. We got an armadillo out of it.
You got the armadillo out of it.
Everything happens for the best.
So the old man is so old that nobody knows his name, Bob.
Wow.
Including
him. Wow.
So he says, the touch of the spirit has been removed.
Thank you.
I don't understand. The spirit only touched him. Why did the rest of us get the nightmares?
You were his friends in his proximity.
We all experienced
it.
You all experienced it together.
Going on a pill because we're going to make out to girl.
Wanlo, it's kind of like when one guy in the chess team ended up getting picked on by a guy at the football team, and then all the other guys on the chess team also got beat up by the football player. Doesn't matter, you're just kind of there. It's like that.
Oh, I just lost it. Texas. Shoot.
Nah, it's
all right. Perfect. Spend the night. Tomorrow you'll return to your homes.
But what if it happens again?
You are not done with the spirit. I have simply removed its touch from you.
I know. What if it touches us again? Do we have to come out here and visit you?
Oh, you will figure out what to do.
Well, here's an idea. How about you join us? I've got CDs and air conditioning, and we could drive back to Pinewood, and then you can do that mumbo-jumbo that you just did, and then you could remove the demon entirely, and you could save an entire university of people. Wouldn't that be great? Thousands of lives saved?
That is not what the spirits tell me to do.
Maybe...
This is your road, not mine.
Well, could you
your journey.
Could you put like a conference call in? Maybe we could discuss it. Possibly.
You haven't been able to turn your phone on since the old lady looked at it. You want this guy to get near it?
It's driving him crazy. He has no access to his phone.
All right. It seems very inefficient. We just take you to where the school is, and you can solve the
day. Yeah. Good point.
I'm just saying.
It is not my journey to be.
Right.
To undertake.
Are we still in danger?
Yes.
Your grandma really just throws you to the wolves, huh? Like, she just lets you fend for yourself. Like, did you have five brothers and sisters and you're the only one that survived? Because, like, they threw you outside and you're the one that beat the rest of them up.
I come from a large family. I'm the first one to go to college.
Oh. Yeah. When you, like, had dinner at night for supper, did they, like, put down all the food and then, like, throw all the kids in there and whoever ate the food won?
Good thing I grew big fast.
Yeah, sure is.
Good night. He goes back into his teepee. He leaves you guys out in the stars. You don't get blankets and pillows this time.
Good night, sir.
Where's Abuelita? Abuela?
Abuela's there.
Well,
she does not go in the teepee, dirty man.
No, so, like, can we at least get back to her place?
It's too late to walk now.
Oh, jeez.
So she goes. She just goes right to sleep there. Doesn't bother her at all. Yeah. Sleeps on a rock. Whatever. A little tougher than city boys.
Yeah. We try to sleep.
Edison manages to find a comfortable spot if he wedges himself sitting in the seated position with his back against the teepee. There's a little bit of a decline so he can sit backwards and eventually he falls asleep.
Wanlo will take off his shirt and ball it up and use it as a pillow.
Is that like a Ned Flanders moment? Is Wanlo like buff?
Oh, yeah, totally. Did you see his picture?
Jackie Chan.
Oh, it's Jackie Chan. Oh, yeah, that's right.
Wait, but it's not that shirt that he took off.
Is that your mesh shirt?
No, it's a different shirt. It's something a little more substantial.
Although, you know, Edison has us. You're all got plenty of sun. Edison obviously got the worst of it.
I don't do well with the sun. My mother tells me I should stay away from the sun at all times.
So the next morning comes, and you wake early. Wakanda leads you back. There's no breakfast. The old man's gone. Or he hasn't come out of his tent.
Edison,
out of his
teepee. Being a very curious sort, walks into the tent and pokes his head in, trying to see.
Before you get in there, Wakanda gets in the way. It's just, that is not for you to look in.
Oh, sorry, Your Majesty. All right. He still kind of cranes his head, but then he turns around and is very respectful.
All right. And she leads you back to her place. You have no idea how she finds her way through it just looks like desert to all of you guys.
Your Majesty, how do you find your way through this? Because it just looks like desert to all of us.
Actually, they'd be more like grasslands than desert, huh?
I picture like stone and hard packer.
Yeah.
But desolate.
Some dust ball.
Tumbleweeds go by every once in a while.
She's got GPS on her own smartphone.
Yeah, right.
She's secretively looking at it, but nobody's looking.
I'm picturing Breaking Bad landscape.
There you go.
Yes.
Yeah, that's good. All right. It's not that far away.
So she gets back to your place. She reheats the last of the chicken soup.
Great. This would be great.
It's Sunday by about noon at that point, so.
We gotta get back. It's just about an 8-hour drive back home.
So she gives Johnny Moon her love. She says, you know, don't be such a stranger.
You got it.
Thank you for the hat.
Thank you very much for your help. And I don't think we ever said thank you to the man. You know, tell him that we say thank you for all the help.
Will do.
If you ever need to fix your home computer and get it hooked up to the internet, give me a call. When you get a phone, you can then give me a call, and I will come over here and I will give you free tentacles.
Well, there is a payphone in the town that I use.
Oh, that's barbaric. Oh my God, how do you get on?
I walk. And I pick it up and I dial and I put the dial number.
Wow. Never. Whew. Cooley, your ways are very strange and mysterious to one such as myself.
She just shakes her head.
I tell her to give us a call, or give me a call if she can think of anything or anything else I can tell.
She says, of course, grandson. Great grandson. And she wishes you well on your trip home.
And does the car start?
Let's find out. Yes, car starts.
It's an uneventful trip home. No more armadillos.
Whew. So it's like any other fantasy adventure. All this stuff happens on the way to the main place.
Of course.
But the way back takes 3 pages. If that. Works.
Really, the armadillo took a page. It just added a lot of flavor text.
It's for the fantasy, actually.
Flavor.
Add a lot of flavor.
It is. Flavor of chicken. Yeah.
So you guys get back at... you make good time. Get back probably around 7, 6:30, 7 o'clock.
Yeah, you know, all that North Texas, like once before you hit like Dallas, Fort Worth, nobody cares how fast you go.
Probably 75 or 80 miles per hour.
Edison does 55 the whole way.
Yep.
It's the most fuel efficient speed.
That's exactly right.
37 miles per hour. That's
exactly right. Joe Diffie blows his doors off.
He's going to have to go visit Paul Anderson at some point to get the belt fixed, I think.
That's a good point. Look at the hook.
Pantyhose are only going to last so long. Exactly. It's only been, I don't even know how many miles, but 8 plus another 4, you know, 12 hours of driving on it. Highway speed driving.
The question is, who in the group is wearing pantyhose?
Oh, you found those on the side of the street.
Oh, we found them on the side of the road. That's right.
I'm not going to tell you what else you found with those.
On the side.
On the side of the road.
Quote, unquote. Yes. Wait a minute. Was it Johnny who said, hey, look, I found some pantyhose on the side of the road.
So you get back, and I think that is a good breaking point.
Yeah, sounds good.
You guys good over there?
How do we sleep?
Yeah, good with that.
Okay.
You sleep better. You have the dreams still, but they're not... they're not vivid waking you up. You know, you still remember them, but they're not torturous.
They're not interrupting our sleep.
Yes.
You know, if the worst that a spirit can do is just give us nightmares, That's really not that powerful. I mean,
show me your arm.
Should we really be concerned about nightmares and a weird box? I mean, don't get me wrong, it's weird, but, I mean, it's not threatening our lives.
School has just started.
If I didn't get away from her, I could have gone up in flames.
There's no telling what could have happened.
I guess that's true. Like pure the French fighter pilot. Just saying, so far, it seems to be following all the science fiction research that I've done, which involves people with cameras walking into haunted houses and hearing a noise, and nothing else happens. That's what we got so far. Got some bad dreams, nothing else. Maybe it ain't so bad.
Dead cats. Burn marks on the arm.
Maybe it got attacked.
The fucking building blew up, caught on fire.
Maybe there's arson going on. Maybe we got an arsonist.
We got thermal images of the ritualist marks heating up.
Yeah, that was weird. That's true. That violates the basic laws of thermodynamics. Huh. Is your arm still hot right now, or is it all fixed?
Still hot.
Maybe.
Well, much better.
Yeah, the sun burned for me on the and it
evened it out.
Can we get you into like one of the mechanics labs? I'd love to hook you up to like a turbine and see if we can actually create some steam out of your arm. That'd be amazing.
It's like a degree hotter than normal.
Huh. Yeah, that's
it just feels like a sunburn, but it's exactly the shape of a hand.
Visibly so.
I'm gonna stop the recording.
Good job. Thank you.